Market City's the place to discover HD Radio. Right now, get a JVC Car HD Radio for a great price and free same-day installation. No subscription fees with HD Radio. Discover it at Circuit City. Some restrictions apply.
DSC at night.
This is the KGB.
Misty in Carlsbad runs an adult toy website. And she says, Dave, please pass this message on to Ruth that she makes my day when she is on the show. Too bad there isn't a way I could tell her that through her own email link. I wanted her to take a look at my website and pick any toy of her choice, and I can ship it to her directly or to the studio. It's my way of saying thanks for being such a great sport when everyone gives her such a hard time. Love all of you and tell Ruth, happy shopping. Misty, spreading the passion in San Diego. So there you go, Ruth. You've scored yourself a free dildo.
What's the website?
What's that?
What's the website?
Misty'sPassion.net. Misty'sPassion.net.
Let me know when they bring it in. I'll get my forklift. We can unload it.
Oh, the thermos over there.
George Chamberlain trying to pour coffee into it. This is a 24-hour newsroom. All right, let's get a sports update with the chainsaw now here on KGB and
Q1. Thank you, David. Shut it down, Chris Boyer. Ruth, 66.
Hello again, everybody.
In the sports world.
Pot racers in action tonight at Arizona and David Wells versus Randy Johnson. Two former Yankees against one another. First pitch 6:40 tonight on Channel 4. D-backs and Padres. As for the modern-day Yankees, A-Rod tattooed two more taters in a loss to Tampa Bay yesterday. A-Rod ties the Major League record for home runs in April with 14. He has six games left to break it. A-Rod's hot start has been compared to those of Hall of Famers George Brett and Mike Schmidt. Brett is known for amassing over 3,000 hits, winning batting titles in three different decades, and missing a World Series game for having raging hemorrhoids. Mike Schmidt is known for 548 homers, three MVPs, and crying during his retirement speech. Hey, A-Rod, do you see yourself sobbing uncontrollably when you run out of preparation age? You know, combining the two players' legacy.
Anytime you can mention with guys like George Brett and Mike Schmidt, uh-huh. the names I've been hearing, it's pretty uh-huh. overwhelming. Probably not as much as I should, but uh-huh. I will someday.
Uh-huh. Some 18 years ago, I left Dayton, Ohio, with two very bad knees and a dream to become a Major League Baseball player. I thank God that dream came true.
Are you crying?
Mm-hmm.
Are you crying?
Yep.
There's no crying. There's no crying in baseball.
First pitch again, 6:40 tonight, Padres D-backs on Channel 4. Meanwhile, in the National Bank.
And speaking of ticket prices, as McEwen bends down to adjust his cleats, we get a good look at his muscular behind. And how much would you pay for that seat, folks? Personally, I'd like season tickets. Mark McEwen, struggling. Oh, for the season so far, but he's due. Park, now set, delivers a slider, just catches the inside corner for strike two. Chan Ho Park, not to be confused with a brand new ballpark down in San Diego, Petco Park, although both have nice seats and a convenient rear entrance.
Oh, God!
McEwen waits. Park kicks and fires low, ball one. 2-1, the count on McEwen. Had a chance to speak with Mark before the game. And as we were chatting, I was standing a step down in the dugout with Mark standing field level, putting me face to face with a gentleman's midsection. I was reminded of being a child, the strong man towering father-like over me, his warm eyes smiling down at me, his loving boy.
Jesus.
For a moment, I wished he'd take me in his protective arms, creeping me, whisper softly that everything's going to be all right. And a 1-2 pitch, called strike three, and Mark does not like the call. And he's letting home plate umpire Pete Hansen know about it. From here, it appears Mark is saying, you're a blind piece of I can read his lips here now. He's saying, you fat cheating mother fat eating ball of and that's it. He's gone, folks. Home plate umpire Pete Hansen throwing him right out of the ball game.
Let's get Football Association. In playoff action last night, Pistons Tony D'Orlando and the Rockets launched Utah. Ruthie's Lakers visit Phoenix tonight. Ruth, they are down 0-1 in this best-of-seven opening round. Yeah, that's a good time. Where are we? Mid-April? It's going to be two more months before the finals are over in other sports, David.
Now, Ruth, is that news that you were talking about in the hallway yesterday public, or is that private?
What news is that?
About you and Luke breaking up?
Yes.
What?
It's public?
I know. It's over, yes.
No.
What happened?
Oh, no.
Did you see his hair?
What happened to his hair?
He, like, shaved or buzz cut his hair. He shaved it off.
Oh, like Britney Spears?
Exactly.
Wow, that's just rubbing it in your face.
You're shallow, Ruth.
I am. It looks awful. And she has a Christian. And I really see the Christian Britney Spears.
I'm sorry?
What was that?
That's what he said to the media when she said, I have a crush on Luke Walton. His comment was, I'm going to crush Britney Spears.
I hate it when guys talk like that.
I know. He's got that big dumb
voice. Why do you
got to
do
anyway.
That? That's
I don't
terrible.
Know. Anytime we do
just
something
makes you sound stupid.
Anytime we do something that women agree with, we apparently say it like this.
Well, you ever hear him talk?
Well, had you not heard him talk before?
What's wrong with the way he talks?
That's daddy talks like
oh,
that.
Oh, my. What?
Luke's voice is like 10 times lower.
I just know Walton. All the great influences of my life, from Coach Wood to Larry Bird, Mick Jagger to Jerry Garcia, I'd have to put Ruth 66 right at the... What?
The great
right
influences of my life, from Coach Wooden to Larry Bird,
heard this already.
Jerry Garcia, and Mick Jagger,
I'd have to put Ruth 66 right at the top
of that great influence. I sure miss
those days when Ruth 66 would feed me in the low post.
Oh, no.
I miss those days when Ruth 66 would feed off my low post.
Damn it.
Cookie Chainsaw Randolph is the inspiration of my life.
What?
So I broke up with him.
The
it's
Prius
over.
Of human beings.
What?
Prius.
The Prius.
What happened to the Rolls Royce?
Cookie Chainsaw Randolph is the Rolls Royce of human beings.
I'm greener than that.
Oh, sure you are.
Speaking of green.
Oh.
But I got a new boyfriend.
Who? Wait, don't say.
Huh?
We'll find out who Ruth's new boyfriend is after the break.
The master of the tease, Dave Rickards, ladies and gentlemen.
4 hours, baby.
It is 7:39 and 10 seconds, and this is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network. Oh, on.
You know, people phone in and make a beef.
Oh, what about?
Well, anything, Joe. Whatever happens to bug you, that's what you talk about.
This is the DSC at Night.
I guess it just gives you a chance to unload. You know how it is. You got a beef, you tell it to somebody, and you feel better.
101.5.
Brilliant. That's just the kind of far-out gimmick we need.
KGB. Artist and title of every song. Online now at 101KGB.com.
Let's start with a patio. Add, a barbecue grill.
Yummy.
Throw in a nice pool with a diving board. Add a nice garden. What the heck? Let's top the whole thing off with a hot tub.
Dude, let's go sneak into the Johnson's hot tub tonight.
Cool.
And let's put a really tall wooden fence around the entire thing.
Oh, man.
At Bank of America, getting a home equity loan to do all of this is almost as easy. There's no paperwork to apply, you get a fast approval, and best of all, there are no fees to get it. It's the opportunity to turn the backyard you have into the backyard you've always wanted. Call 1-800-900-9000 or stop by your local Bank of America to get started. Bank of America. Bank of Opportunity.
Closing costs apply for loans over $500,000. Equal housing lender.
On the Border, Mexican Grill and Cantina presents the ultimate five combo, where you choose five of your favorite Mexican favorites all on one plate, just the way you love them. Choose from delicious enchiladas, mouth-watering chimichangas, overstuffed quesadillas, and more. Don't forget On the Border's award-winning tasty margaritas. Visit On the Border Mexican Grill and Cantina in Mission Valley, Mira Mesa, El Cajon, Escondido, and OnTheBorder.com for catering information. It's On the Border for happy hour every weekday from 4 to 7 p.m., where you'll find great food and drink specials. On the Border, see what sizzles.
The seatbelt sign finally went off. You're tired, but thankfully out of that cramped airline seat and in the terminal. As you head down the long escalator to baggage claim, what a treat to see that well-dressed Cloud 9 sedan driver holding up a sign with your name on it. You feel special, and you can relax. Nobody has had to come to the airport. No gas, no fighting traffic, no parking fees. You just sit back, unwind, and let that courteous Cloud 9 driver take you to your door and bring in the luggage. For over 12 years, Cloud 9 Shuttle has been providing San Diegans with carpooling services to and from the airport. Their services reduce traffic and help keep San Diego clean. And by using the latest GPS technology, Cloud 9 reduces pollution and traffic congestion throughout San Diego. Efficient routing and carpooling means efficient use of fuel. You can help too by choosing Cloud 9 for your next ride to the airport. Book your reservation easily on cloud9shuttle.com or call 800-9-SHUTTLE. Thanks for helping Cloud 9 keep America's finest cities safe and clean.
Male enhancement in 3 to 5 seconds? Is it possible? Hi, I'm Stephanie Siever from Maxiderm, and nobody knows spontaneous male enhancement like we do. Recommended by leading physician, Dr. Michael A. Savino, Maxiderm is that hot new topical you've read so much about and seen all over TV. All we need to prove it is 3 to 5 seconds, and you'll see for yourself how quick it works. Call now and find out how to get your free trial today. Maxiderm's patent-pending formula can help restore your confidence and performance, creating a level of intensity and satisfaction you thought was no longer achievable. Intimate encounters happen in the moment. That's why we created Maxiderm. Male enhancement in 3 to 5 seconds. Get your free trial while supplies last.
Call 800-553-7034. Maxiderm is sexual performance. 800-553-7034. That's 800-553-7034. For your free supply today, call 800-553-7034.
At Carlberger Dodge World and Carlberger Chrysler Jeep World in La Mesa, we're having our giant on-site tent event this weekend only. Remember the name, Carlberger, and that nobody's going to beat Carlberger's prices, and I mean nobody. Carlberger is located off Interstate 8 in La Mesa.
Cruise over to California Speedway this Friday through Sunday for the AMA Suzuki Superbike Challenge. It's full throttle entertainment for the whole family with the Motorcycle Expo, live entertainment, stunt shows, and much more. Call 800-944-RACE or visit californiaspeedway.com.
I never miss the 5-cent sale from BevMo.
5-cent sale is buy one bottle of wine, get another bottle of the same wine for 5 cents.
Ooh, that's my favorite.
Well, I certainly wish the 5-cent sale were available all year.
All good things must come to an end, I guess.
I'm sad to see the 5-cent sale go, but I know that next time they have it is a good time to stock up on even more wine.
Oh, it's sad when it's over. There's still some wine left.
Hurry in. BevMo's 5-cent wine sale ends soon, only at BevMo.
Yeah, sure. So you want me to describe my world in 10 words or less? Rock, hard rock, classic rock, country rock, alternative rock. You know, stop me when I get to 10 here.
Whatever your world is about, AT&T can deliver it at the speed you need. Love music? Then here's the perfect way to explore a whole world of music fast and access it even faster. Sign up for AT&T Yahoo High-Speed Internet, the fastest internet in town for the price, and wireless from the new AT&T, and get one free year of unlimited music from Napster. That's fast access to over 3 million songs you can take on the go. Jazz, hip-hop, country, whatever you want. Yeah, including rock. Go to att.com/freemusic or visit a singular store near you. AT&T is the most complete provider for the way you live with TV, broadband, home phone, and wireless. The new AT&T. Your world delivered.
Comparison of major broadband providers. Express speed or higher requires purchase of SyncPhone and 2-year term for new wireless customers. Other restrictions apply. For details, call 1-866-416-6471 toll free or visit att.com/offer details.
The best new cars make the best used cars. Toyota certified used vehicles are the best. Take a closer look. All Toyota certified used vehicles come with a 160-point quality inspection, a vehicle history report, a 3-month, 3,000-mile comprehensive warranty, a 7-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus 24-hour roadside assistance.
We've got what it takes, San Diego.
Upon
upon closer inspection, it's easy to see why over 1.5 million TCUVs have been sold in America. So get a great deal on a certified used Toyota car, truck, or SUV. Based on AutoData Corp, cumulative data for certified used sales, comprehensive warranty from date of certified purchase, powertrain warranty and roadside assistance from date when first sold as new. For details, see your San Diego County Toyota dealer. Toyota, moving forward.
101.5
KGB.
Thank God there's DSC at night.
DSC at
That's
night.
101.5 KGB, baby.
All right, Ruth has acknowledged that she and Luke Walton are no longer an item.
I dumped him.
To the, really?
Yes.
That sounds like what a chick says right after she gets dumped.
Whatever she needs to believe.
Luke apparently has turned his affections towards Brittany and has even, in a sign of unity, has shaved his head to match hers. Yeah, exactly.
And he looks terrible in it.
Because he used to have that kind of like loosey-goosey blonde fro thing going on.
Well, he's got thick, curly red, just these beautiful red curls. And he's
a redhead?
He's been kind just like the daddy. He's
not as red as Bill, at least, he's in our movie. You could look at it.
It's been pretty red lately, but it's been getting a little shorter a little shorter. But now there's nothing left. Just buzz cut the whole thing, which looks really good on Kobe. It's like, half inch long.
It's funny because I remember more than once we've talked about how our women should not cut their hair because it's a deal breaker. And I walked in the last time we were getting our hair done. I walked in and Nicole was sitting in the chair and they said, "Guess what we did?" And I was like, "Oh, no." And you've always kind of said, "What do you mean it's a deal breaker?" And yeah, Here comes the karma train.
No, I understand.
Show you exactly why it's a deal breaker. So Luke is out and there's a new boyfriend. Let me guess. The guy in the NBA.
Yes.
But I'll a big give you black guy.
Yes.
Okay.
But here's the really big hint. He's not just a side player to Kobe.
You are just getting cold.
He's a star.
Why do you have to be like this? What are you going to do now?
Because I got a new boyfriend.
You're going to write bench warmer on the side of his car now, go all Al-Qaeda on him?
Well, no, and he still starts sometimes.
Why can't you break up nicely?
He's getting better and everything, but he's no longer for me.
I know.
Well, here's the thing. Ruth always goes for the NBA players, and it's a big black guy, and that's pretty much where I lose. See ya. I mean, who? Michael Jordan?
No, Cook. It's like he's on another team.
I know.
Currently playing.
I know.
Hakeem Olajuwon.
I know.
He's young.
I'd say it, Jane.
Carmelo Anthony.
Yes!
Wow.
Who's
that?
He's beautiful.
An all-star from the Denver Nuggets.
Yes, he's the head guy. And ever since Iverson, Allen Iverson, Dave.
Yes.
Ever since he started playing with the Nuggets, the two of them have just been awesome. And they are contenders.
30-30.
This is the series to watch, them against the great San Antonio Spurs.
You're such a jock.
They are battling. It's fun to watch.
Yeah, it's a good looking guy. Thank you. Emily just popped his picture up there for
beautiful.
Me.
He's beautiful. Shut up.
Yeah.
He's like 6'10".
Yes, Emily?
He's not cute.
No, he's not.
He is too cute.
No, he's not.
He's not.
He looks like a punk.
That picture is not very terrific, but he is a cute guy.
Whatever. It's him. He looks like a punk.
He's like a $5 millionaire.
Prejudiced about what?
You see a picture and you say punk.
Right.
He's like 20.
What did we just do earlier?
Yeah, with
pictures
the women.
Of hot chicks. Would you do them or not?
Would you do Carmelo Anthony?
And who was the most passionate of them all here, Cookie?
You.
I'm just pointing it out. I'm not criticizing them.
Not much.
Right.
Carmelo, Carmella.
And they call
Carmelo,
him,
Carmella.
No. They call him Mello for short. Number 15. Ivan Chase.
What do you call him for
short? I call
short?
Him Hoosie What's It's right. Never heard of you before for short.
He came in the NBA the same years as LeBron and as Luke, so he didn't really get a lot of attention.
Yes, he did. He won an NCAA title with Syracuse. Are you kidding?
Come on. American losers. You don't know.
March Madness is bigger than the NBA, if you'd like to know a little something.
That was college. I don't pay attention to that.
Okay.
But when he came in, he was a big star, but LeBron got all the attention. Even Luke got a little attention.
Can we talk about Kathy Lincoln for a
Dwayne Wade got all the attention, which is well deserved. And now finally Carmelo's getting some.
And he's Sing the it, sister. Cute of all of them.
Shut up.
Who's cute?
I'll go.
Of all the ones she just listed, LeBron, Dwayne Wade. Yeah. This guy is a doofus.
Who's the
cutie? You think Dwayne? I mean, LeBron is cuter than Melo?
I do too.
Your eyes checked.
LeBron's I do too. Pretty cute. I think you know. And I wouldn't say either one's necessarily gonna win a beauty pageant, but I would say LeBron is more attractive than the picture that she put up there.
But you must have found
you need a new picture, and you need to know Melo like I do from all angles and lighting.
What? Look at that.
What school did he go to, Che?
Syracuse.
Hello. Oh, yeah, you said that.
Just make that up.
No, I didn't. He won an NCAA title.
Yeah, he said it earlier. Because he's a great player. He could become one of the greats. Definitely the team to watch.
Well, Ruth chose the ugly one.
Wow.
Greg Oden is next.
I don't know him.
I don't know him either. He's college. Shut up.
And Nene. How about Nene? He's pretty cute.
Who?
He's the third battler, third warrior on the Nuggets.
Boy, do you remember that joke that we told about 15 years ago? This guy was driving around and he rolls up on a rural town and he can't believe it. Everywhere he looks, people are having sex with sheep.
Yes.
I mean, he's just blown away by this. He's astonished by it. But apparently that's what they do in this town. Everyone has sex with sheep. And yeah. After a few days stay there, he finally gets convinced and they walk out and they see him having sex with a sheep and everyone gathers around and starts laughing and pointing at him. And he's like, what's going on? And they say, you chose the ugly one.
Well, he's a way better player than stupid Luke.
Oh, my God.
This is such an ugly turn. Beautiful, beautiful cornrows. His braids are lovely.
Yeah, those cornrows, that always pushes me over the top. That's what I always look for in my
picks. It's really neat designs.
Bo Derek says hello.
Well, it looks better on him than stupid Luke's no hair.
They don't look good on anybody. I've never seen anybody with cornrows and look good, ever. I take it back. Because she doesn't do completely cornrows, but that Alicia Keys can kind of pull it off.
Because she has a stunning face.
It's just not that good look. So sorry, Ruth, you chose Diogo.
What's his name again?
Carmelo Anthony, Denver Nuggets.
You can call him Melo for short.
I'll be calling him nothing because I'm bored out of my gourd.
Oh, God. I punched the ball. I'm a basket. I punched boring 12 minutes ago.
All right.
Oh,
Let's
just
talk about
the
dad
of him.
Screaming again.
Wow.
Don't get mad just because you chose the ugly one.
He's not ugly.
Ugo.
He's beautiful.
Choose someone hot next time, will you? I got to watch all this
just
crap.
Watch him play and you'll change your mind.
It's the NBA, Ruth. Nobody watches the NBA.
You're such a liar.
You know what? Voice maybe
she makes me watch it.
Maybe he'll just terrible. Do it from behind. Then you won't have to see.
We watched NBA last night instead of that stupid dancing with a stupid
star. Yeah,
stars.
Voice in the head. Do you like...
It's a good point, Boyer made.
Huh?
Next time you get one, they make him pop you in the pail so I don't have to look at him.
Works for me.
KGB.
Don't worry, you won't feel a thing.
The DSC at night.
Till I jam this down your throat.
KGB. 101.5 KGB.
They're giving away a car a month, every month this year. And not just any car, but hybrids, Priuses and Civics. Great mileage, great for the environment, and great for the community. All North Island Credit Union members have a chance to win. If you haven't heard about the island's Car a Month giveaway, you're probably not a member yet, but you can be. All San Diegans are welcome at the island. Then you can enjoy island rewards, free gifts, special rates on auto loans, free checking, and how'd your child like to be a kickoff kid at a Chargers game? Island membership has all kinds of benefits because the island is a different kind of financial institution. It's a place where you can feel welcome, secure, relaxed, and even have a little fun. The Car a Month giveaway, a year full of island rewards, and a lifetime of service. Now, more than ever, the island is right for you. Must be 18 or older. No purchase necessary to enter or win. Full details on myisland.com.
When it comes to the competitive world of mortgage lending, it's easy to be confused. This is Richard Dela Cruz, native San Diegan and president of U.S. Capital Lending. Here at U.S. Capital, we are in the business of creating clients for life. Let us find you a fixed rate loan that fits your lifestyle by calling 800-917-4757. At U.S. Capital Lending, we quote real rates on real loans. U.S. Capital Lending, giving you the loan you want that suits your needs. That's 800-917-4757.
Come see the biggest names in sports and entertainment at the Toyota Celebrity Classic, hosted by Stan Humphries this Thursday through Sunday at Morgan Run in beautiful Rancho Santa Fe. Walk with stars like John Elway, Jerry Rice, Ray Romano, Emmitt Smith, Mike Schmidt, and Marcus Allen. Get free autographs. Enjoy fun and games for the whole family. Proceeds benefit Rady Children's Hospital, San Diego. For ticket information, visit stanhumphries.com. It's big time golf and big time celebrities.
Rubio's introduces Rapsaladas, the tastiest salads wrapped in savory tortillas. Try Chipotle Ranch Rapsalada or a Baja Caesar Rapsalada. Both come with chicken, shrimp, or mahi-mahi. They're one part salad, one part burrito, all parts delicious, and they're only at Rubio's.
You asked us for a truck that can tow more and stop at the pump less. Well, we heard you loud and clear. Introducing the all-new Chevy Silverado, an available 315-horsepower engine that gets 20 or more EPA-estimated highway miles to the gallon. No other pickup out there delivers a better combination of power and efficiency. Plus, it's backed by the best full-size truck powertrain warranty out there. The GM 100,000-mile, 5-year powertrain limited warranty. Whichever comes first, see dealer for details. The 2007 Silverado, our smartest truck ever. Only from Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. This is our country, this is our truck. Power and efficiency information based on 2006 GM large pickup segment. Dependability based on longevity. 1981 through July 2006 full-line light-duty truck company registrations. Excludes other GM divisions. See dealer for details. See your Southern California Chevy dealer or visit sdchevydealers.com today.
Order! Order in the court!
It's time to render your decision. You've made up your mind, but you're twitching from the itching, squirming from the burning, and everyone's hanging on your every word.
I should have used Preparation H. Quick recess!
Where's he going?
You should carry Preparation H portable wipes, the discreet way to get big relief. They're convenient little packets that hold very big wipes, so you can cleanse, cool, and soothe to get relief even when you're not at home.
Order! Now, my decision.
Preparation H portable wipes. Big relief to go. Use as directed.
Just people having a good time.
Yeah, I really do.
Country. It's not how you spell it. It's how it makes you feel.
Always makes me feel very good about myself.
Feel good country. U.S. 95.7.
Win a VIP office happy hour at Trophies. Register at 101kgb.com and you can score your office free food, drink, and a limo escort from La Costa Limousine and some great prizes. Next event Thursday. Register at 101kgb.com now and make Trophies your next office happy hour.
Well, I'm afraid we're going to need another stool sample.
This is the DSC at Night.
Not for medical reasons. My robot needs food.
101.5 KGB.
I climbed up on that machine from Torch, from Hell Torture Machine yesterday. Knock out a couple miles and finally got caught up on Sopranos yesterday.
Poor Junior.
Uncle June, wet in his pants.
Oh, no. How about the letter to Dick Cheney?
I thought that was great.
I didn't see.
What was he writing our vice president about?
He's just, you know, what I don't get about this show is, you know, it'll finish one week and it comes back the next week and they've got a whole new scene, a whole new location, all new characters, and they don't even introduce them. And I didn't miss anything, right?
No.
I mean, all of a sudden, we're just there at Uncle June's, wherever he is.
Nursing home.
I don't know what. No, it's not a nursing home. It's because there's young people in it, too. There's crazy people. There's young people. It's some kind of like jail for the insane or the infirmed or something.
A sanitarium. You know?
I don't. I'm just suspecting it's that.
So all of a sudden, you're just there with all these new characters. And Uncle June is almost like rooming with this young guy who seems to be about, I don't know, 20?
Sure.
21? Who's got some sort of temper issue.
Yeah.
And he's Uncle June's buddy.
Oh, no.
And they're in, like, crazy jail together. And so he's taking letters for Uncle June.
Typing them on his computer.
And Uncle June is dictating this, going, as you... As you, you know, can relate, I too had an unfortunate accident when a gun was in my hands and accidentally misfired. And I forget what he was asking Dick Cheney to do, get him out of jail or something like that. You know, it was an accident. I didn't mean to do anything. Yeah.
To get some help and advice on this issue.
Can you get me out of jail?
Yes.
But how about Uncle June taking a knockdown beating from that kid at the end of the show?
We got violence every week now, man.
That was a weird show. I mean, I really thought for a minute there at the end of that show that Tony was going to kill Paulie.
I did too.
So
I really thought it was going to happen.
So did Paulie.
Yeah. I think Tony thought Tony was going to kill
Paulie. I know. I thought he was going to do it.
He reaches down and picks up a beer and tosses it to him instead of the hatchet.
God, that was scary.
I don't know how Paulie sat there on that boat. It's the same boat or at least the same area where they killed Big Pussy.
And he imagined
And Paulie and Tony did it together.
Yes.
And so Paulie's freaking out that now it's his turn. And he gets on a boat that's got a bloody hatchet, a baseball bat, an axe, and a gun.
Yeah.
No problem. Let's go. Yeah.
Plenty of liquor and food.
Yeah, that was weird.
That's good, though.
I'm finally caught up on that.
Suspenseful.
Haven't caught up on Entourage. Was that good last week?
I liked it a lot.
Yeah.
Because of the new hot chick agent.
Yeah.
She's just added a whole different dimension in it for the boys.
All right. Did you guys watch 2.5 Men last night?
Mm-hmm. No.
Yeah. Oh, I haven't seen that one yet.
It's excellent.
Heroes.
That show is still good. Heroes was on last night?
Back on, yeah.
It was last night?
Yep.
Oh, man. I got too much TV to catch up on.
I know. There's so many good shows.
Was Allie Larder on last night?
Yes.
Oh, damn it. I don't care what the plot line is as long as she's on.
And she's going to be on a whole bunch next week, too.
It's awesome. Yeah, last night, the boys go gay on 2.5 Men.
With each other?
The boys go gay.
I heard the commercial. Do you think I'm gay? They both said that.
Yeah. They were convinced that they were gay. So much so. See, Alan befriends a man who is gay.
Oh. Right.
And Alan, through a series of pretty quick events, becomes convinced that he himself is gay. And so they're driving around one day, and Alan just stops the car, pulls over, and kisses him.
Whoa!
Because I think I'm gay.
Oh, my God.
You guys didn't see that?
No.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
That one happened.
The guy says, you're not gay.
You're doing it all wrong.
Gay at all.
Some gay guys don't really mind that.
And who is this? Karen wrote to me and said, watching that, Dave, reminded me it's time to do the gay test. I know you've done it before, but it's been a while. Let's go through the gay checkup list, shall we?
Yeah, sure.
Who's the gayest here on the show?
Boy, Abramowitz.
You got to have Bromo in on this one.
All right, Emily, can you get Bromo on the phone for me?
You got it.
Find out if he is the gayest of them all.
Well, yeah.
You think he is?
Yes. Especially with this beard information.
Because he's got a fixation on Dave and freeze frame pictures of Dave and wants to shave his face just like Dave and wear Dave's clothes and has a picture of Dave in his bathroom next to his lubrication bottles.
Are you gay?
No, and first of all, I don't have lubrication bottles.
Wait. I just want to know if you're gay.
No.
I'm gay, I'm queer, I'm a homo, a butt pirate.
I don't understand why you sing that song, but say you're not gay.
Because I'm clowning around for one thing, and that is part of my gay opera that I'm writing.
A lot of heteros write gay operas.
Sure. And when you're standing around in the halls with Bromo, some guy comes by and he'll whistle at him and catcall and make cracks about him, but not girls.
Depends on the guy.
Yeah, if you're attracted to him.
Keep score here, people.
Yes.
Guys only.
Okay.
If you answer yes to these, I want you to write down a check mark, and we'll see who's got the most check marks.
Yeah, Bromo.
I'm a little worried about myself.
Be honest, Bromo.
All right. Number one, if you're over 40 and you have a washboard stomach complete with six-pack, you are gay.
What is a washboard? What is that?
You ever seen the guys like at the beach who are really, you know, like ripped up and you can see their stomach muscles? They call it a six pack because there's six like bumps there.
Oh, right.
Like Jesus.
You don't have one.
I don't have one, though.
You don't have one.
No.
Jesus was ripped. Oh, I hope he wasn't gay. Never hung out with the chicks.
But he was dead at 33.
He was, so he didn't make it to 40.
That's true. All right, number two, if you have a cat, you are a flaming homo.
Who's
marking that one down, Dave?
I should mark it down twice because my cat is really the size of two cats.
Yeah, he is.
Cookie. I have two cats.
Bromo has two.
A cat is like a dog, but gay.
Cookie, do you still have a cat?
No.
Oh,
so
she died?
Not gay.
Oh.
He ate her.
He ate it.
Or Amy.
Amy, that's it.
There's a, are you having a little trouble figuring out why a cat is gay, Bromo?
Yeah.
Okay, let me explain it to you. See, a cat is like a dog, but it's gay. It grooms itself constantly, but never scratches itself. It's got a delicate touch, except when it uses its nails. It whines to be fed. And just think about how you call a dog. Killer! Come here! Get your ass over here, killer! Now think about how you call your cat. Bun Bun, come to daddy. Bun Bun.
I've trained my cats to go after things.
No, you haven't.
Yeah, I have. They sick flies. A fly is zooming around. It'll go over and get it.
They listen all
Mark
the time.
Mark it down. You're gay.
I already marked it down. I have two cats.
Number three. If you suck on lollipops, ring pops, baby pacifiers, or any such nonsense, rest assured you are a gay lord.
Wow.
Bromo bites pen caps.
Not anymore, Boyer.
A straight man only sucks on barbecue ribs, crab claws, raw oysters, crawfish guts.
Ew.
I don't do either one.
Gross. I think maybe you're a southern gay man.
I don't do lollipops, ring pops, baby pacifiers, or any such nonsense. Anybody here?
I do.
Oh, God. You're a lollipop guy?
I do Tootsie Pops.
Yeah. Mm. I'll give you an example, Chainsaw, how I know I'm right on this. They have a very nice tradition out at the Aviara Golf Club.
Yeah.
The marshal will drive around, make sure everything's in order on the golf course, and he'll bring out a large jar of Tootsie Roll brand suckers.
Yum.
And offer in all different flavors, the good ones, too.
Mm-hmm.
And offer them to the golfers.
Yeah.
And I never take one just because I don't dig them.
It's a chocolatey center.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they're so good.
Boyer, yes, no?
I'm not a sucker, no. A sucker,
Chang,
sucker.
Yes, no?
No.
I am not. Boy, Bromo?
Yes.
All right. Next, if you refused to go in a public bathroom, you crave a deep homosexual relationship.
Mm-hmm.
A man's world is his bathroom, and he goes where he pleases.
Uh-huh.
So.
That would be Dave.
No, I've gotten over my problem.
Oh.
Yep.
Shucks.
Chucks?
She wants you to be gay.
No, I just want you to have something to mark down.
I did. I had to put down the cat thing. If you drink anything other than regular coffee,
Boyer,
you like a high hard one in the pail.
Damn it.
All right.
Boyer, gotta
yes,
mark it
I'm
down.
Mark that down.
Chain, gotta mark it
yeah.
down. Bromo, gotta mark it down. I'll just sip at my regular coffee.
My favorite sports analogy word that I never heard till I met you guys. The high hard one.
High hard one.
Hey, Dave, you and I have regular coffee, but...
No, dude, you drink steamed milk.
No.
And we all know
no.
what tragedy. You drink
I'm drinking a Coke right now, a Pepsi right now. Does that count?
No, you have to put down because you are well known on the record. Oh. You're in a movie.
You're
on the record as ordering steamed milk. We saw you do it in the movie.
I put it down.
If you know more than six names of colors or four different types of dessert, you might as well be handing out free passes to your ass.
Jesus.
I like creme brulee and chartreuse.
I love creme brulee, but you know my favorite is tiramisu.
I like chartreuse tiramisu, which combines colors and desserts.
I got to mark that one down, but I don't know anybody who wouldn't mark that down.
Come on.
I mean, Boyer, you're going to mark that down.
Periwinkle.
What guy isn't going to mark that down?
Come on.
Now, this is interesting that you said that, Chang, because I didn't write this. I'm just reading it. If you can pick out chartreuse, you're gay.
You know, I don't know what color that is.
It's sort of yellowish, isn't it?
I thought it was.
I don't know.
It's green.
Oh.
I sure as hell don't know.
Boyer.
Yeah. It's just the go-to gay color.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because that messes.
If you know what a fraisier is...
Oh, crap. What's that show?
I don't know. I should be gay for knowing how to pronounce it.
Yeah.
It's got to be a dessert. All right. If you drive with both hands on the wheel, forget it. You're dying to tune a meat whistle.
Tune a meat whistle.
A man only puts both hands on the wheel to honk at slow-ass drivers or to cut the a-hole off. The rest of the time, he needs that hand to change the radio station, eat a hamburger, hold his beer, scratch the boys, or play with his girl's hoo-ha-ha in
Jeez.
The passenger seat.
Nice.
You guys are always saying 10 and 2, 10 and 2.
I got 2.
I have 1.
3.
1.
Bromo.
I've got 4.
Oh.
Yay.
Let's play his theme song.
I'm gay, I'm queer, I'm a homo, a butt pirate.
Hmm.
But I don't drive my car.
I got a penis strapped to my chin.
I don't drive my car with two hands on the wheel, so I didn't check that down.
Okay, that's fine.
What do you do with your other hand?
It's on the stick shift.
Ruth. Oh, there's one more. Mm-hmm. If you pretend to blow a guy in the back of a restaurant, you're gay.
I will write that down.
You practice with a cue
number.
How's
that coming along, by the way? Remember you said your friend, what is it?
Tom.
Tom would be thrilled to come in here and reenact the oral sex play that you and the other fellas used to do at the restaurant.
Joke.
Have not heard from him.
You haven't heard from him since the day you called him.
Right.
He's vanished from your world.
Pretty much.
I can't figure that out.
He's busy.
That doesn't make any sense
He's
to me.
He's busy.
You guys busy?
I don't understand it.
That was the past, Bromo. It's time to move on.
Did you watch 2.5 Men last night?
Never seen the show.
You ought to check it out.
Oh, you're
You've never
kidding.
Seen it? Great still show. So I hate doing funny. That.
Great show. You okay today?
Yeah.
All right.
How about you?
Everything's great.
Did you see Entourage?
I haven't seen it yet.
Oh, man.
I'm going to, believe me.
It was funny, huh, Bromo?
You know what happens? You know what my problem is?
What?
I got women living at my house.
No, I know.
Yes, you do.
It's a big problem for me.
Because?
But, Dave, you're a big Ari fan, right?
Well, I like to watch these shows while I'm doing my damn cardio workout. Mm-hmm. I mean, I really hate it. I hate it.
That's a great
but
thing
I know it's
do.
Huh?
That's a great time to watch them.
Well, that's what I do.
Fast is the time fast.
It helps me get through the hating the whole thing.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So I go up to where we have the elliptical thing, mm-hmm. which I'm pretty sure was invented by Satan on a bad day.
Yep.
And I go to the Cox DVR, and I'm going through my list of recorded shows, and all my Entourage and all my Sopranos are gone, and guess what's there
what?
In place?
Uh-oh.
What?
About 50 Oprahs.
Oh, God. God damn it!
Yeah. Yeah.
Who does that?
The women in my house.
Tape all episodes regardless what time.
No, yeah. No, you've
the
got
50 Oprahs on there.
Oh. You've got to confiscate the remotes. You've got to find a way to password protect that.
Calm down, Boyer.
No, you don't do that! You don't need 50 goddamn Oprahs!
I
you
agree.
Don't need one!
I agree. Hey, I agree.
Hey, Dave.
Yeah?
I had this old girlfriend years ago who would make
fun
of me.
Is this the one who pooped your skirt?
No.
Oh.
This is one after that one. Who would make fun of me, go out of her way and chide me for watching golf. And yet, I would come home and she'd be on a marathon stunt of watching the Cooking Channel,
ugh.
$40 a day,
ugh.
Oprah, mm-hmm. Tyra Banks. Mm-hmm. Give me a break.
Women shouldn't be allowed to watch TV.
Oh, stop it.
It's true.
Why do you watch?
Look at you, Ruth. All you do is go home and watch the NBA.
Yeah.
Ugh. I do not. I watch a lot of stuff.
We watch Dancing with the Stars.
That's no, right.
And anything
don't.
That has Kathy Lee Gifford.
No.
The greatest actress of our time.
She is, voice.
We're lucky. Let's all say a prayer
Shut
to Jesus.
Up. Go ahead.
Thank you. Dear Jesus.
Yes.
This is the voice. Hey, turn it.
I had the cough, excuse me.
This is the voice in the head speaking.
Yes.
Thanks for making Kathy Lee the greatest actress of our time.
Wish she was dead.
Love's voice in the head.
World is better with her in it.
It's true.
No, it's not. She's awful. Oh.
And thank you for making Dancing with the Stars. Unless your dad made that, then pass it on for me.
Hey, she was on.
Stop it.
Sorry. Well, you invented it.
Did I see what?
Did you see he was on Letterman? Was it last night or the night before? The guy that was bounced off American Idol.
Oh, Sangina.
Yeah, and he did a top 10 things that you learn from American Idol.
Don't give it away because we're going to play it in the news.
Okay, no, I won't. All but right. Was that last night's show that he was on?
Yeah, I believe so, yeah.
Yeah.
He's making his tour. This is his 15 minutes of fame. Access Hollywood. And
so do you prefer to be known as Gaylord or Astastic?
Oh, I like the second one.
I do too.
Which one do you prefer?
You got that ass and quit.
You talking to me?
Yeah.
Well, you won the gay quiz.
But I'm not gay. I am not gay. I'm actually.
Five out of seven.
God. Who wrote that stupid thing?
You did.
A hetero.
Hetero. Well, good for him, but I am not gay.
No.
But are you hetero?
No, I like women.
I think you are hetero.
I go out with women. I'm straight like a bow.
How's what?
A bow is not straight.
Well, an arrow that's on a bow. You know what I'm talking about.
Not really. How's Wilt the Stilt doing?
Fantastic. I'm going to see her. We're doing Chinese food tomorrow night.
Right on.
No, she's great.
All right. Pop her in the pail yet?
No.
What are you waiting for? You know she wants it.
We are having it.
All tall girls like it in the pooper.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
No, they
that's
don't.
A fact.
I didn't know that.
We are having a very slow, extended relationship.
Uh-huh.
Relationship.
Who's extended the most, you or her?
Relationship. Okay with that.
She strapped it on yet?
No.
She's gonna.
You know you would take it if you wanted
you.
You
know you would.
Bro, you're so full of it, Ruth. You I wouldn't take it from anybody.
If this girl, if Wilt the Stilt, said to you, we're going to have sex and I'm going to wear a strap-on or we are done, what would you say?
We're done. Sorry.
Oh, you lie.
As much as I would hate to have that happen, I'm not.
Take it from a complete stranger, mm-hmm. just not to hurt her feelings.
Oh, I don't take it from anybody.
What if Sarah out at the front desk, you know, your little Kit Kat friend? What? What?
No, I wouldn't take it from Sarah either.
Right. If she says, I'm really tired of my boyfriend, I'd like to take the strap on and just drill you.
Holy cow.
You'd hop right up there on the clear channel. Welcome, Dassel.
What not?
On all fours. Be gentle.
I would respectively say no.
Respectively?
Respectively.
Yeah. You'd bleat like a sheep.
Would not.
Would do.
No way. No way.
Hetero.
I'm not. I'm straight, damn it.
Oh, well.
Breeder.
Not yet, thank God.
You know, we had to have his girlfriend come in with a strap on and recreate the scene.
From Weeds?
From the restaurant.
Hey, Boyer.
The restaurant.
Boyer, why don't we
Tom won't do it, we ought to have her come in and do it.
Why don't we still come in and do it?
Yeah. Live show.
Hey, would you do that?
Boyer,
would you do that?
Why don't we have Santee Al with his barber pole come on in and do you from behind?
Would you do that?
No.
Why? You'll
I'm
do
not
it with a guy.
From anybody behind.
You wait. We're just saying you recreate your little knobber play that you used to do in front of all the fellas at the restaurant that we don't understand because we weren't steakhouse employees.
Nope.
And you do it with Jeff, but you won't do it with your new girlfriend.
First of all,
it was
is
Tom.
The answer yes or no?
We were
Tom.
Clothed when we did the knobber
right.
thing.
Okay.
So what?
So you can be clothed with your girlfriend.
I don't give a knobber to a girlfriend. They don't.
Oh my God. Wow. I'm starting to figure out why.
Shut up, Boyer. I don't go out with a girl who's got a crank.
But it's a fake.
It's just a strap on.
Yeah.
No, strap on nothing.
So if we get Wilt the Stilt over here. And we give her a strap on. Will you recreate the scene for us?
First of all,
is it yes or no?
It's no.
Why will you do it with a guy, but not with a girl?
Because back then, it relieved pressure from the job.
I bet it did.
It still does.
So, okay, Bromo.
Listen, baby, I'm under a lot of pressure.
You got a hot girl with a strap on. You got a guy with a strap on right in front of you. Which one do you
pretend to play with?
Yeah.
None of them.
You have to choose.
You have to choose.
So would you rather?
Is it going to be Tom or Wilt the Stilt?
Well, I wouldn't want to embarrass Wilt.
Is it Tom or Wilt the Stilt?
Let me finish, damn it.
Just say it.
What are the
give
other?
Me your long reason.
Because you're trying to make me look gay here.
Not that hard.
You don't have to work at
it's
it.
Not
which Tom. One do you choose, Tom or Wilt?
Tom.
Oh.
Let me explain why not.
Don't have to.
We know
we
why.
We already know.
Don't have to.
Because.
Don't have to.
Out of respect for Wilt the Stilt, I wouldn't embarrass her.
Turn it up.
But with Tom, I'm a naughty girl. It's just kidding around with Tom. I'm a naughty girl.
Plus,
I'm not a naughty
familiar.
Girl.
You've already done him.
I gave her a hickey. Okay, with that. Shut up, Ruth.
That's funny. Give her a hickey.
You gave
her
a hickey. Boyer.
Right
that
on the strap
was
on.
Chainsaw, say, you idiot.
Cute.
I gave her a hickey.
Cute.
Turn it up. Right, turn it up.
Turn it up.
Turn that guy down, will you?
LA Woman, the Doors on 101.5 KGB. It's Bromo hanging with you on a 2 for Tuesday. And the only thing worse than an LA woman is an LA woman who wears a Dodger hat.
Shut up.
Yeah, Dave, shut up. That wasn't me.
You guys shut up. Knock it off.
F you.
F you.
Swear at the puppets.
Dave, she's right. F you.
Dumb. Knock it off. Get off. Get out of here. Shut up, Ruthie.
Dave, don't tell her to shut up. Get your hair cut yet, you dumb cinema.
This is White Rabbit H-E-B.
Oh! I got a penis!
Okay, already! I'll just keep playing those awful breaks.
All right, thanks for clearing all that up for me.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye. President introduced it as Law Woman.
Huh?
Never mind. L.A. Woman. Whatever, okay.
What?
That was a speed bump. Your car is now out of alignment.
It's called show on tape. I'm going to edit that out.
I mean, if you can't be at least mildly interesting, then shut the hell up.
You're right.
Boyer had, Bromo had complete ownership, dictator for life of the barrel.
Yeah.
And with one sentence, you evicted him and assumed residence.
Wow.
In the barrel.
We're out. Yeah, but I've seen the way he left it. He's not getting his deposit back. Somebody have a towel in here?
Ass.
This is the DSC at Night.
101.5
KGB.
KGB.
Free love. Free love.
It's radio
free
the way it was meant to be.
Free love.
Absolutely free.
Yeah. Woo.
It's HD radio. You just gotta love it. Get yours today at the Sharper Image.
Turn those lights off, start spinning those balls, and get your glow on every Friday and Saturday night at Surf Bowl in Oceanside. It's cool, it's crazy, it's extreme glow-in-the-dark bowling, and nobody sets them up and knocks them down better than Surf Bowl. Gather your friends, load up the family, or just bring yourself. It's wacky, it's wild, it's extreme glow-in-the-dark bowling every Friday and Saturday night, 10 p.m. at Surf Bowl in Oceanside on Coast Highway, one block south of Oceanside Boulevard. Details online at surfbowloceanside.com. Been bowling lately?
Your car won't start and you're going to be late for work. Your child has a cold and you want to keep him home from school. Problems you know exactly how to handle if you have a phone. But there are people who don't. That's why the new AT&T offers Universal Lifeline Telephone Service. It makes phone service affordable for people who otherwise couldn't afford it, with discounted connection fees and a reduced monthly rate. Call us to see if you qualify. Additional discounts may apply if you live on federally recognized tribal lands. So if you don't have phone service, you owe it to yourself to check out Universal Lifeline Telephone Service. Call an AT&T representative at 1-800-446-5651. Or if you have computer access, go to att.com/lifeline. Call today. There's a good chance you can afford phone service. The new AT&T. Your world, delivered. Universal Lifeline Telephone Service not available in all areas. Terms and conditions subject to change without notice. Additional eligibility requirements and certain restrictions apply.
On the Border, Mexican Grill and Cantina presents... The ultimate five combo. That's right. You choose not one, not two, not three, not even four, but your five Mexican favorites served all on one plate, just the way you love them. And on the Border, you'll choose from delicious enchiladas, mouthwatering chimichangas, overstuffed quesadillas, fabulous tacos, and much, much more. So for a limited time, visit On the Border Mexican Grill and Cantina now and create your ultimate five combo. And don't forget to try On the Border's award-winning tasty margaritas. Choose one from the menu or create your own.
Yeehaw!
On the Border, Mexican Grill and Cantina in Mission Valley across from Nordstrom's Rack. Mira Mesa just off the 15. El Cajon across from Parkway Plaza. Escondido's North County Fair across from JCPenney. And at ontheborder.com for menu specials and catering information. And remember On the Border for happy hour every Monday through Friday from 4 to 7 p.m. where you'll find great food and drink specials. On the Border, see what sizzles.
Have you driven an F-150 lately? With 11,000 pounds of towing, best-in-class payload, and the strongest frame, F-150 is built for San Diego. Now get 0% financing for 60 months only at your San Diego County Ford dealer. If you haven't driven a built Ford Tough F-150, you haven't driven a truck. Check it out at sandiegocountyford.com.
Built for San Diego sunshine. Take a ride.
Not all buyers will qualify. 2007 F-150 with 60-month Ford credit APR financing at $1,667 per month per $1,000 finance with 10% down. Excludes F-150 Harley-Davidson. For APR, take new retail delivery from dealer stock by 5/31/07. Residency restrictions apply. See dealer for qualifications and details.
Live streaming online now at 101KGB.com.
Furnished by Mattress Discounters.
Hi, this is Kasim Osgood from your AFC West champion, San Diego Chargers, inviting you to join me and some of my NFL friends for my second annual Celebrity Golf Classic, benefiting my mentorship and scholarship program, Team KO. Created to get involved directly with as many children in San Diego as possible in order to influence and encourage them to pursue success. It's all happening on Monday, May 14th at the Del Mar Country Club. For more information, call 619-583-4955 or www.afefoundation.org.
For crystal clear digital sound plus a ton of extra HD stations, go to Radio Shack and bring home a subscription-free HD radio. It's the best thing you can do with your radio.
HD radio. Discover it at Radio Shack, where you don't just buy stuff, you do stuff. Available in select stores or online.
The DSC at Night.
Hey, don't worry. You don't have to make up stories here. Here. Save that for court.
101.5 AGB.
It's 101 KGB and Q103. Still to come this morning, got to talk about a new way for you to get your caffeine. What is Joan Rivers up to? I have a new exciting way to get your computer to tell someone to go to hell.
Sweet.
We all need that.
Yeah.
And Chucko's encounter with a moose. Yeah.
Wow.
That's right. All coming up for you this morning here on 101 KGB and Q103. Right now, let's do sports with a chainsaw here. Good morning.
Well, good morning. Thank you, David. And hello again, everybody in the sports world. The San Diego Padres resume action tonight in Arizona. Phoenix, to be specific. Classic pitching matchup. David Wells versus Randy's Johnson. Padres D-backs first pitch 6:40 our time on Channel 4. Yankee superstar A-Rod tattooed two more taters in a loss to Tampa Bay yesterday. A-Rod ties the Major League record for homers in April with 14. He has 6 games left to break it. At this pace, A-Rod would finish this season with 126 homers, 306 RBI, and a .400 batting average.
Isn't that interesting?
Yes,
yeah.
Kind of. In bowling, now we're getting interesting.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Go on YouTube, search Awesome Bowling Trick Shot.
Oh, I saw this.
Awesome bowling trick shot.
It's killer.
Norm Duke slowly spins a ball down the lane, then throws a second ball that takes out 9 pins, and then the first ball picks up the spare.
Yeah, but what's even more impressive is that the second one goes around.
Yes.
It turns around it.
And even more impressive, it is such a cool shot that one woman who was watching it actually fleetingly thought of having sex with him. See, it's a bowling joke that went awry.
What? I don't get it now. Explain this to me. It fleetingly went... What?
Because well,
nobody wants to have sex with a bowler.
Yeah.
Oh, that is mean.
John Barcroft had all the tail, and he was in a bowling league.
I know.
No one wants to have sex with a bowler?
Hey, Ruth, ever had a customer stash his bowling shoes at the foot of the bed, install a hand dryer near the side table, and Chris Boyer, just what is the difference between Ruth and a bowling ball?
Oh, you can only get 3 fingers in a bowling ball.
Wow. Okay, I don't know.
What a
head up. It was wrong. And it's my bad.
That's not where you were going with that?
Kinda.
Hey, today
in 1995.
Isn't there another one about sex? Oral sex in a bowling ball?
Please tell Voice in Ruth's head.
Well, if you had to, you could eat a bowling ball.
Oh, was that it? Was that it?
Anyway, go to YouTube, search Awesome Bowling Trick Shot.
Dean of
it is amazing.
Losers
is more like it. Well, hey, I think everyone piled onto that mess. Hey, today in 1995, news broke that longtime ABC sportscaster Howard Cosell passed away at age 75. Mm. 1995. That's weird because just 2 years ago in 2005, Sugar Ray Leonard was in studio. Remember that?
Yeah.
And Howard called into the show.
We do have one fan who wants to say hello to you here before we let you go. Good morning. You're on the air at KGB with Sugar Ray Leonard. Hello.
Hello again, everyone. This is Howard Cosell.
Yes, Howard.
Howard. Hello, Sugar.
How you doing, Howard?
As you know, I abhor cheap radio impersonations. Disgusting trend of imitation. This is actually me.
Right.
Equipped with speed, ability, and charisma, Sugar Ray Leonard filled the boxing void left when Muhammad Ali retired in 1981. Leonard faced legendary lightweight champion Roberto Duran in what may be the most anticipated non-heavyweight fight in history. In a fast-paced battle, Duran dethroned Leonard with a unanimous 15-round decision. Leonard regained the title when Duran quit. In the eighth round of their rematch, no moss, no moss.
Yes, yes.
In 1981, he then returned to the welterweight division for a unification showdown with WBA champ Thomas Hearns. Leonard and Hearns waged a memorable war, but Leonard, behind on all three scorecards, managed to knock Hearns out in the 14th round with a flurry of punches. And then I died, so I don't know anything that occurred after that.
He's dead.
Yes, indeed. Howard Cosell, part of the legendary Monday Night Football crew, along with Dandy Don Meredith and Frank Gifford.
Now to honor America, please join in the singing of our national anthem, sung by television and recording star, my wife, Kathy Lee Gifford.
Kathy Lee Gifford, the world is a better place with her in it.
That was the greatest Super Bowl of all time.
Wasn't it great? Was.
Yes, indeed. Yeah, the one where the Chargers got spanked by the 49ers.
Who cares?
I know. Kathy Lee sang. That's all that matters.
Kathy Lee was there. The greatest entertainer of our time.
I agree. Meanwhile,
you're deaf.
In the National Bath.
Hi, this is Mari Povich. What's the deal with Chainsaw and this National Bath?
There's no oxygen for the brain.
Skitball Association thing. I mean, if it's a joke, I don't get it. Is it supposed to be funny?
Yeah.
Skitball Association.
No.
In playoff action last night, Orlando got bloomed by Detroit and the Rockets tabernacled Utah. And Ruthie's Lakers, I think it's Ruthie's Lakers,
yep,
visit
still.
Phoenix tonight down 0-1. And do your Nuggets play with your beloved Carmelo?
That's tonight?
I am asking you.
Oh, I'm not sure.
Okay.
But I love Kobe as my favorite Laker.
Okay.
Kobe, because he scores. Because he's awesome. God, are you kidding? The Kobe show?
Yes, indeed. In other sports, David.
Hi, this is Mari Povich. Whenever I'm in San Diego, I make it a point of listening to my close and personal friends, Hudson and Bauer, right here on Jammin' Z90. Crank it up, girls.
The one's right. Dead.
It is 8:37 and 35 seconds. This is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network. Oh, my.
This is the DSC at night.
101.5
KGB.
101KGB.com.
Come see the biggest names in sports and entertainment at the Toyota Celebrity Classic, hosted by Stan Humphries this Thursday through Sunday at Morgan Run in beautiful Rancho Santa Fe. Walk with stars like John Elway, Jerry Rice, Ray Romano, Emmett Smith, Mike Schmidt, and Marcus Allen. Get free autographs. Enjoy fun and games for the whole family. Proceeds benefit Rady Children's Hospital, San Diego. For ticket information, visit StanHumphries.com. It's big time golf and big time celebrities.
If phones could
talk.
Hey, man.
What?
I'm Steve's phone.
I don't really socialize.
You're a phone and you don't socialize?
We are nothing alike.
You're a flip phone, I'm a flip...
You are a cricket phone, I am not. I can tell by the way you keep talking and talking like there's not a care in the world.
Sounds like someone has overages.
Maybe I do, and maybe I'm stuck in a 2-year contract and get charged for every text.
Well, I'm pretty lucky. With Cricket, I experience true unlimited, with unlimited calling to any network anytime, plus free text and picture messaging.
Are you rubbing it in?
Yes. Yes, I am. I'm better than you.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Right now at Cricket, buy the UT Starcom 7025 for just $69.99 and get your first month of service free. Plus, pay no activation fee and get free text and picture messaging with every new rate plan, all without signing a contract. Cricket. A smarter way to do wireless. Features are phone dependent. Unlimited refers to calls and messages made and are received within the Cricket markets. U.S. long distance excludes Alaska. Other restrictions apply. See store for details.
Visit Cricket Wireless at over 150 locations in San Diego. Go to mycricket.com/San Diego to find one near you.
This is a story of a guy named Russell and how a sprained ankle changed everything.
Ouch, I sprained my ankle.
After the accident, Russell wasn't going anywhere for a while.
I'm not going anywhere for a while.
House-ridden, he realized his ankle wasn't his only problem.
Honey, this room's pink.
It's mauve.
Russell knew he didn't want to live in a mauve-colored room.
I don't want to live in a mauve-colored room.
So, he hobbled to his computer and logged on to Bank of America for a home equity loan. It was easy. He was able to apply in minutes, he got a quick approval, and he didn't pay a single fee to get the loan.
Hey, I didn't pay a single fee to get the loan.
In fact, getting that home equity loan was so fast and easy, Russell was able to live the good life even before he was back on his feet.
What is this?
This is our new cinema room.
Well, your new cinema room is still mauve.
Yeah, I blocked all that with a movie screen.
Go to bankofamerica.com/home equity for the opportunity to make your home your castle. Or stop by your local Bank of America to get started. Bank of America, bank of opportunity.
Closing costs apply for loans over $500,000, equal housing lender.
Investments and securities involve the risk of loss.
You may not think of yourself as being affluent. You may not think of yourself as a high net worth investor. But it doesn't matter what kind of car you drive or the home you live in. If your investments are $500,000 or more, you're a high net worth investor. And one thing we know about you is that there are 8 common mistakes high net worth investors can make without even knowing it. We're Fisher Investments, and we've put together a special free report just for you. It's called the 8 Biggest Mistakes Investors Make and How to Avoid Them. It's yours free just for calling 1-800-955-1252. Just avoiding any one of these mistakes could help you better reach your goals now and over time. As your portfolio grows and changes, strategies need to grow and change. That's why this is valuable information you must see. For your free copy of the 8 Biggest Mistakes Investors Make and How to Avoid Them, pick up the phone now. Call 1-800-955-1252. That's 1-800-955-1252.
What a sale right now. The Giant.
Pearson Ford.
Our lowest advertised monthly payments ever. Just check it out.
www.pearsonford.com. Take a look at the Focus, Fusion, Ranger, Mustang, Edge, Explorer, and Super Cruise specials.
Hurry, sale ends 4:30. The Giant. Pearson Ford.
There's one station that brings you the information that matters to you. The news that makes a difference in your life. The talk that you care about. Set a preset for AM 600 COCO. AM 600 COCO. San Diego's news and talk station.
Mail enhancement in 3 to 5 seconds? Is it possible? Hi, I'm Stephanie Siever from Maxiderm, and nobody knows spontaneous male enhancement like we do. Recommended by leading physician Dr. Michael A. Savino, Maxiderm is that hot new topical you've read so much about and seen all over TV. All we need to prove it is 3 to 5 seconds, and you'll see for yourself how quick it works. Call now and find out how to get your free trial today. Maxiderm's patent-pending formula can help restore your confidence and performance, creating a level of intensity and satisfaction you thought was no longer achievable. Intimate encounters happen in the moment. That's why we created Maxiderm. Male enhancement in 3 to 5 seconds. Get your free trial while supplies last.
Call 800-553-7034. Maxiderm is sexual performance. 800-553-7034. That's 800-553-7034. For your free supply today, call 800-553-7034.
When it comes to the competitive world of mortgage lending, it's easy to be confused. This is Richard Dela Cruz, native San Diegan and president of U.S. Capital Lending. Here at U.S. Capital, we are in the business of creating clients for life. Let us find you a fixed-rate loan that fits your lifestyle by calling 800-917-4757. At U.S. Capital Lending, we quote real rates on real loans. U.S. Capital Lending, giving you the loan you want that suits your needs. That's 800-917-4757.
This is the DSC at Night.
Go to bed!
101.5.
KGB.
We were on vacation last week. We went all kinds of places. Shelly went to Arizona. I went to Vegas. Chainsaw to New York City. Boyer went to Sante. Chucko went to Alaska. And check this out. Chucko, you know, she's an interesting chick. She got up there, and one of the first things she wanted to do, two things she wanted to see. She wanted to see people throwing fish.
Yes. I think that was on the way in Seattle, actually, but yeah.
And then when she got to Alaska, she wanted to see a moose.
Moose.
Wanted to see a moose. So there, we have an old friend up there, Jen Shevlin, who works at a radio station in Anchorage, Alaska.
Yes.
And they were talking on the phone while Jen was on the air, and Chucko says, I want to see a moose. And so Jen turns on the mic and says, if anyone's got a moose in their yard, will you call me and tell you? I mean, just totally using her show, which is fun.
Yeah.
And they got nowhere. So you know where they sent her to see the moose?
Mm-mm.
The zoo.
Oh, jeez.
Who cares?
It's your prize animal.
You had to go to the zoo to see a moose?
I did.
That is lame. You could
have
stayed here.
I know. It was the saddest thing ever.
Yeah. Did you finally see one?
A bear and a moose?
There were three different kinds of bears.
Yeah.
A moose and a snow leopard.
That was the whole zoo?
And the bald eagle. That was all that was out. Everything else was like...
cold.
In their little burrow.
Yeah. Hiding. It's cold. Figure it out, you know?
Right.
There's still snow here. We're going to be hiding.
They could claim they've got dodo birds and dinosaurs, but they're hiding right now because it's cold.
They totally did. It was hilarious. We were walking around. It was... kind of a sad looking zoo.
Did you finally see a moose on the loose?
We did see a moose on the loose, and it was massive. And we had moose steak for our Sunday dinner.
That had to offend the moose you saw walking around.
I know, right? It was kind of weird.
Tastes like chicken?
It was kind of like lamb. Mm-hmm. It like kind of had the same texture as lamb.
You good?
And it was a big animal, right?
It was huge.
You know what the funny thing about a moose is?
What?
It craps the size of a peanut.
I know, isn't that weird?
I feel like I saw crap everywhere on the ground there. There was always some kind of feces somewhere.
Well,
it was really weird.
The attraction of Alaska
right
there.
I know, hey, that's where I go on vacation, right?
What, did you take anything in particular away, a thought or sight or an experience from your trip to Alaska?
I have a scratch on my chin from a fish.
Yeah, got slapped by a fish during the whole fish throwing.
By a fish. Yeah. Jesus. Literally. Yeah. Did get to see a bald eagle flying, which was very cool.
Wow. Yeah.
On the loose?
On the loose.
Wow. That's cool.
Yep.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
We were driving back from the resort. And what else did I see? Lots of bearded men.
Yeah. A lot of lumberjack stuff going on there. A lot of flannel.
I have more flannel and more fleece than I've ever seen in my entire life.
Yeah. Is it true that there are like 90 guys for every girl?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did you hook up?
Suck. No, I did not.
Oh, get it all Eskimo style.
I know. It was horrible.
Rub some blubber on me, you lumberjack.
All you got was the fish? Oh, my God.
Yeah.
So, I mean, and the people were just like a bunch of hippies, and it was cool, though. It was.
Would you go again?
Absolutely.
All right.
Yeah, it was gorgeous. It was light until 10:30 at night, and the sun started coming up at 4:30, and it was really, really cool. I've never been to a place like it before.
You know, it's not that, I know that the Alaska, the land of the midnight sun, whatever, I don't know which one is which, but at my brother's house in Michigan, and he doesn't even live in the Upper Peninsula.
Right.
Mm-hmm. It's light until 9:45.
I know.
Yeah.
You know, you can still see like the purple, the orange and the purple in the sky at 9:45 at night.
Yeah. In the summer, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were driving back from the bar on Thursday night, and it was just weird to be driving back and have it still be kind of light.
Yeah, it is weird. It's cool, though.
It is really cool. I really liked it.
It's cool.
It's dark. Like, when it's Can imagine that. It gets dark. But
where we vacation.
Where we vacation.
It gets so dark.
But I mean, when we were driving to the airport on Monday morning, to have it be like that for 24 hours a day, I would probably lose my mind. It was just
I have friends who live there, and they say that blackout shades are total mm-hmm. necessity. You've yeah. got to have them in your house.
Or yeah. else could you sleep?
I don't know, but every room we were in and stuff had like really thick curtains and everything in it. So,
well, congratulations on seeing that moose at the zoo
and thank kissing you. A fish.
Thank you.
Had a trip. Thank you, Chuckle.
All right,
to have her back. There is a new way for you to get your caffeine, and you don't have to drink a cup of coffee.
What do you do?
It's caffeinated soap. Have you heard about this?
No.
If you don't have time for both a shower and a cup of coffee in the morning, caffeinated soap is here. The manufacturer claims that Shower Shock.
Good
releases,
name.
Huh?
Good name.
Shower Shock releases caffeine that is absorbed into your system and provides the same hit as two cups of coffee.
Wow. Interesting. Damn. I'd try it.
It is infused with peppermint and citrus so you don't end up smelling like coffee.
Sweet.
The company that makes it, Think Geek, says that every full body wash with Shower Shock soap will provide the equivalent of around two cups of coffee.
That's awesome.
It's absorbed through the skin and into the bloodstream. It has the same effect as if you were drinking coffee. Your blood pressure, your pulse rate will go up, makes your brain feel more alert and awake, and it'll stay in your system for about 4 hours, same as two cups of coffee.
But what about when you wash all your tingly parts? Do they get all caffeinated?
Well, you know, the blood, the coffee that you drink, the caffeine gets into your blood, and the blood goes to your tingly parts. So.
Mm. It just seems odd.
Have you ever used tingly shampoo?
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Holy cow, you get that on the wrong spot, and it's like, whoa! Man.
I guess those coffee enemas just never hit it big, huh?
I guess.
Hard to believe they didn't catch on, Ruthie.
Well, they need to leave out the stir stick when they're...
Guess what Joan Rivers is going to do?
What? I heard about this.
She's going to run... She is 74 years old and is going to run the New York Marathon.
Good grief. Why?
What
a nut.
I got to tell you, she looked in pretty good shape, body-wise.
74.
Well, she said everything's snipped, nipped, and tucked.
I was thinking that, but she had a flat belly and her legs.
Sure,
and
she's had that.
Looked good. Mm-hmm.
She had everything done.
74, going to run in a marathon.
I saw her last week in New York City, about 10 feet away from her, probably. Mm-hmm.
I found a great way to have your computer give your insults, or whatever message you want. As a matter of fact, and I will put a link to this up on our website so that you can use it. It's called Karaoke Messenger.
Uh-huh.
And you just go to the website and you type in whatever you want it to say. And it's pretty cool. You can choose the, you have a choice of like a 50s Vic Damone kind of guy or a 50s Rosemary Clooney kind of chick to come out and sing your song. You type it in and then all of a sudden a curtain opens up. And this chick comes out, and there's just a dog on a couch for no reason,
mm-hmm.
and she'll sing your song. Would you like to hear it?
Yes. Yeah.
Check it out. Here we go. Curtain opens. Here she comes.
Chris Boyer, you are such a freaking dude. Washback.
The dog agrees.
Yes.
Punctuated by the dog bark.
Who wants to hear it again?
I do.
I should play it with a guy, see what the guy sounds like.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Have him say
Chris Boyer, you are such a freaking dude. Washback.
What did you want it to do, Ruth?
To say, Burmal, I'm a butt virus. That famous ditty.
It's going to give me a second to reload that. Bromo, you're such a hetero.
This is the DSC at Night.
101.5
KGB. 101.5 KGB. You asked us for a truck that can tow more and stop at the pump less. Well, we heard you loud and clear. Introducing the all-new Chevy Silverado, an available 315-horsepower engine that gets 20 or more EPA-estimated highway miles to the gallon. No other pickup out there delivers a better combination of power and efficiency. Plus, it's backed by the best full-size truck powertrain warranty out there. The GM 100,000-mile, 5-year powertrain limited warranty. Whichever comes first. See dealer for details. The 2007 Silverado, our smartest truck ever. Only from Chevy.
the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. This is our country. This is our truck. Power and efficiency information based on 2006 GM large pickup segment. Dependability based on longevity. 1981 through July 2006 full-line light-duty truck company registrations. Excludes other GM divisions. See dealer for details. See your Southern California Chevy dealer or visit sdchevydealers.com today.
Your name means a lot to you, but in the wrong hands, it can mean more to someone else. With Wachovia, if your identity is ever stolen, dedicated fraud specialists will work with you one-on-one to help recover any lost funds. And they'll stick with you until your identity is restored. Protecting your good name. Another feature of Wachovia Free Checking. Stop by, call 800-WACHOVIA or visit wachovia.com. Are you with Wachovia?
Free checking is for personal accounts only. Wachovia Bank N.A. and Wachovia Bank of Delaware N.A. members FDIC.
Okay, we get there in 5 minutes. We're going to get this business. Everybody ready?
Wait, wait, wait. We need theme music.
I came to bring the
Nothing wrong with getting your mind right before you get down to business, especially after you've been grinding away for months. On top of the day job, you work the night shift at home, emailing drafts of the presentation at 3 a.m., talking to your partner on the East Coast more than you talk to your girl. Now, that's how you got ready for the meeting that could change your life. Subscribe to AT&T Yahoo High-Speed Internet and Wireless Service from the new AT&T. Do it now, and qualifying services will get you a free year of unlimited music from Napster. It's the new school of music to go from the new AT&T. Your world delivered.
Express speed or higher requires purchase of Sync phone and 2-year term for new wireless customers. Other restrictions apply.
Celebrity divorces. I found it. And then did I lose it again? What the hell? What is my problem today?
Today?
Huh?
Today?
I'm sorry, Jay.
Nothing.
What you're going to say? What did I do with it?
Do you have mine?
It's right where you left it.
You got the top 10 most expensive?
Oh, no. I have a specific couple.
I had it here just a second ago. Here. Got him a scatterbrain.
It's going to kill Boyer.
Yeah, that's why I'm doing it. Oh. Specifically for Boyer. Okay. Top 10 most expensive celebrity divorces. All right. Number 10, Mick Jagger and Jerry Hall. Somewhere she got between $15 and $25 million.
Wow.
What do you think of that, Chris?
That's crazy.
Weren't they married a long time?
A long time. They were together more than they were.
I don't care. What did she do?
She pumped out about like five kids.
Five kids. Jeez.
Well, so what? Just because she's a brood mare, does that mean she gets $15 million?
She was a supermodel.
Broodmare.
She put up with a lot.
Getting more than a receptacle for Mick Jagger.
Lionel and Diane Ritchie settled for $20 million.
Wow.
Michael and Deandra Douglas.
Oh, that's the first one.
The first one, yeah.
$45 million.
Whoa.
James Cameron, director of Titanic, director of...
Almost Famous.
The... Mr. Governor, you're...
Terminator.
The Terminator movies. Thank you. I'm sorry.
I was trying to let you do it.
I'm a scatterbrain today. I apologize. James Cameron and his wife, Linda Hamilton, she was the star of the Terminator.
Right, right.
$50 million to break
up.
Paul McCartney and Heather Mills still pending. It's going to be $60 million.
She should have just kept her leg together.
Kevin Costner and Cindy Silva, $80 million.
Holy cow. That had to clean him out.
Huh?
Did he have $80 million?
He's got a lot of dough.
Huge dough. Harrison Ford and Melissa Mathison. I read, by the way, while I was on vacation that Harrison Ford finally proposed to Skinny Minnie.
Calista.
Boney Maroney.
Yeah.
You know what it cost Harrison to get rid of Melissa Mathison, Chris Boyer?
$92
million. $85 million.
First wives made out like bandits.
Had her killed for less.
Steven Spielberg and Amy Irving. $100 million.
Another first wife.
Neil Diamond. And Marsha Murphy. Want to take a guess? She's number two on the list.
$118 million.
$150 million. Million dollars.
Holy smokes.
Oh.
Guess who's number one? Anybody?
Wait a minute. Oh, it's got to be the Donald.
It is not.
Oh, really?
It is not. He's smarter with his money.
Yeah, I guess he is.
He went ahead and got divorced when he was broke.
No kidding. That's probably why he went bankrupt.
Number one on the list, Chris Boyer.
Wow.
Just recently announced that they're breaking up.
Brad Pitt.
So they must have had a... the camera operator and
Oh,
Julia Roberts?
Julia Roberts.
No.
That's just rumor.
Shane, do you know who it is?
I do know who it is.
Who is it?
It's Michael Jordan.
Yes, it is.
Oh. And Juanita.
And what's
Michael and Juanita Jordan, they were married for over 15 years.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's only speculation at this point because they haven't settled it yet. But they're thinking now right around $225 million.
Holy cow. Wow. What's he worth, about $1 billion or more?
Doubt that. $225 million.
Jeez.
But you got to assume that the price they're talking about is approximately half of what he's got. That's what most of
that's insane.
Really?
For any other party.
First wives. Mm-hmm. All those years.
Who cares?
You give up your career for his.
You know, she could have given up her career for a guy who works at a gas station.
But she didn't.
Really?
When they got Michael Jordan, are you nuts?
She gave up her career. And she couldn't have given up her career for a guy who worked at a gas station. They wouldn't have had the money.
Who cares if she gave up her career?
Well, that's worth money.
So,
okay, here's $1 million. You never would have made this on your own in your whole life.
Well,
I'll keep the other $224.
Well, the point is they're at a community property state. Yeah, well, she gets half of it.
And we got child support, too.
The point is she got 15 years where she got to sit on her ass and go to Bunko and shop at Williams-Sonoma and not have to collect S&H green stamps.
Hello, what about all the kids?
Why don't you be grateful for that?
Really?
15 years of that.
What about
she gets 15 years of sitting on her ass. And now $225 million.
She's a mom. She pumped out a bunch of kids.
Well, you know what?
She stood by him while there were a million NBA groupies going after
her. She knew that when she was going in.
The nannies raised the kids.
Right. Yeah.
Let's not be naive.
Come on. You know what? You want to talk about somebody who might actually deserve something? How about a mom who busts her ass with the kids? Who, you know, spends time with the kids, who treasures them and works hard to raise them.
So Chris Boyer for single mothers.
Yes.
That might work with single moms.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be a single mom. Single moms aren't the only ones who treasure their kids.
So you know Mrs. Jordan or what? That she went shopping.
He does. He knows her personally. He saw her in Williams-Sonoma because he was over there shopping the other day.
I know for a fact she didn't have to work very hard. I'm positive that she had a housekeeper.
And child raising
is... Work hard at what?
Exactly.
And child raising's easy?
She had nannies. She probably had six for each kid.
That doesn't change the law.
Yeah,
she wouldn't be asking for that kind of money.
No one's fighting the law. We're just saying it's crazy.
Well,
it's insane.
Yeah, it's
crazy. She's not being paid relative to her contribution.
Yeah, but you know what? Michael Jordan knew the law when he got married to her. And he, you know, who knew that he was going to earn that kind of money? Well, you did. That's the way it goes. Well,
Michael Jordan didn't know that he was going to get divorced. That's just, look, you know, if you...
I love the Chris Boyer black
18
black
years
accent.
Of your life.
It's Michael was in the room.
I thought Uncle Remus was here for a minute. Come on, give me something for Uncle Remus, Pop. Come on. Uncle Remus, I'm dropping on you and I get nothing?
Yeah, sorry, okay.
You guys suck.
Hope to go back to the Briar Patch.
Oh, man.
Briar patch? What's a briar?
Now you have to explain it to
Emily.
It's a patch with briars in it.
It's a briar patch.
Call it a briar patch.
Look, you know, we talked to about a guy who was injured by a doctor. He had the wrong testicle cut off.
What does this have to do with divorce?
And the most he can get for pain and suffering is $250,000.
That's right.
Why don't you put a cap on what any non-earning spouse can get?
Yes.
Good
because
luck with
flat
that.
Out...
Why don't you work to have the laws changed?
Because it's not within my power.
Because you would never get married because you're terrified that you would get divorced and you lose half of all your Napa stuff.
Oh, I'd have a prenup. Absolutely.
I lose half my pistons. Outrageous.
She should have kept her legs together. She's got all my pistons now.
Napa grubbing whore.
I loved the whole go to Bunko, shop at Williams-Sonoma, not have to collect S&H green stamps.
I know. Who does that?
That's what she's doing. She's got it. She's on easy street.
Yes, I agree.
Be grateful for the 15 years that you got to have sex with this guy, a third of the time he was having sex, and have your life in a wonderful little bucolic environment.
Bucolic, David. Not to be confused with the plague.
Or bulimic.
Thank you.
Let's go around the room. Yeah. Who here thinks that Michael Jordan's wife deserves $225 million? I'll go first.
Deserves.
No.
I think it's just me and you, Shell.
Yeah.
I'll go second.
No.
No, I don't.
We're sticking with the broads.
Yeah.
And why do you think she deserves $225 million?
We're sticking with him.
50-50.
That's the law.
No, that's the law. That's not deserves it.
Why do you think she deserves it is what I said.
For sticking with him.
What's so hard about
that?
Was
that awful? I mean, she could have left.
Well, we don't know.
It's hard being married. Come on. Everybody knows that.
Well, you're insinuating it was bad.
That it was bad.
If he's on the road all the time. She's helping him build his career.
He's probably working out
a whole lot.
Wait.
Is she coaching him with a jump shot?
He's on the road for 41 games out of the year.
That's a lot. Nuh-uh. You know, I wouldn't like if my husband traveled
that
much.
Well, she knew that going in.
Yeah, but she understood that.
She knew that going in.
Well, he understood he could get divorced going into it. So he should have made...
How she deserves $225 million?
If it's as simple as that, because he didn't cover his butt. If he really, you know, wanted to protect his money, he should have prenupted it.
You're
oranging
with the apple again.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, sure you are. I mean, why do you think she deserves that money?
Because he was too stupid to protect his money. Let's just put it that way.
That's the lamest excuse I've ever heard.
No, you're not going to accept anything else.
Give us something that makes sense.
Make something good.
So you deserve your paycheck here because they're too stupid to have talked you down?
Good grief. Well, have you ever gotten as much as you want in a negotiation session? They do try to talk you down.
It's talking about deserving, not you know what you get. I mean, in show business,
did Michael Jordan deserve to make that kind of money? No, he got the best deal for being the best player at the time.
Oh. He deserved more. I'll refute that. Actually, I will refute that.
But did he deserve the Nike endorsement? Did he deserve all of that?
Yes.
See, this is where it's apples and oranges to me because I just don't.
In the real world, he was a greater value to the Chicago Bulls than what they paid him, even though they paid him $25 or $36 million a year, because he increased that franchise. Without him, the franchise wouldn't have increased by hundreds of millions of dollars.
How many rings did they have?
Period. Six.
So was he underpaid then?
And the
In terms of the deservingness of it, yes.
And the Chicago Bulls, prior to Michael Jordan, were just like, whatever.
Terrible.
Whatever.
Some people think he's the best basketball player that ever lived.
Or athlete.
He's a legend.
He deserved that. He earned that money. He deserved that money. Absolutely.
He was a two-sport athlete in college, wasn't he, Shane?
No.
Okay.
Have no idea how that was going to help out the conversation at all.
None.
But I bring it up, even though it's completely untrue, and was it going to help at all?
Sorry, I thought he played
Ruth,
baseball.
What do you think? Why does Juanita Jordan deserve $225 million?
Just because he has it.
Does that mean you deserve money that other people have?
Well, she's not married to other people.
Right. So she deserves it just because it's there.
Because he has it, yeah. And she was there the whole time, too.
Now, if
through
he
the
was...
the whole career.
Hey, Ruth, if he was...
I'm ready to join Alfalfa in the He-Man Woman Haters Club today. Tell you.
I didn't make the law.
We're not talking about the law. We're talking about what people deserve. You know, what's fair.
But life isn't really about what people deserve.
This is the question to you. You're not in a court of law. You're here on a radio show. There's no judge. There's no laws.
I still say, yes, she deserved it.
Because it's there.
Because he made that much and she deserves half.
Hey, Ruth, let me ask you this. If he had gambled into a $255 million debt or $500 million debt, would she have to pay
half of that?
Would she deserve to owe $250 million?
No.
Why not? So it only works one way?
She gets half of what's left.
Well, she would also assume half of the debt, Ruthie.
In terms of that logic, in terms of your guys' logic, she'd have to.
She would.
She'd owe two. Here she walks away owing $250 million. That's her net walk-away loss.
Was she ever on Dancing with the Stars?
She should be.
She should be. She's beautiful.
Is she beautiful?
She's not a celebrity.
Juanita? Yeah, she's...
Well, just by the mere fact that she married Mike.
Mrs. Jordan.
She's Mrs. Jordan. That makes you a celebrity.
Yeah. That alone gives her value.
I bet we will see her on Dancing with the Stars, along with Kathy Lee Gifford.
Oh, God.
Yes.
She quit saying that name.
You're talking.
That's a show.
Oh, Jesus.
You know, that's a show that we take the next day off because we're just too exhausted after watching it all the night before.
Watched it? Mm-hmm. You watched it last night's show?
I missed it last night.
Oh.
TiVo'd, I'll have to watch it today.
Lucky.
You're not watching it.
I'll bet you did.
It's terrible.
Really? The show you didn't watch, you know it's terrible?
You haven't said anything that makes sense yet today, Ruth. You are over.
You think that show's good?
You do.
And we're going to have clips
you're
on
the
it.
Only,
I mean it just
you're the only one on this show, and I don't care if it was just for 5 minutes. You're the only one who watches it.
And now you guys watch it, and I don't.
I don't watch it. I don't watch it. I've never watched it
Chainsaw
once.
Chainsaw and Cookie have been watching
Chainsaw
it.
Chainsaw and Cookie.
I mean, Chainsaw and Shelly.
Well, sorry. Cookie did, but Chainsaw did not.
He took the night off.
I meant Shelly.
Ruthie, I watch it out of compassion for you.
I don't watch
so that you and I will
show.
Have some show in common to talk about because I don't watch the NBA.
I think we should have a Dancing with the Stars intervention.
Oh,
because she's lying about her using.
That's sad. And you wouldn't. Who would know better than you?
She's a dancing user and she's lying about
and
it.
We just enable her.
I know.
Is
she's
it a
lying.
12-step or a 2-step program?
Good God.
Well, 2-step jazz hands.
Clever, wasn't it? Voice in the head.
That was funny.
Oh, Ruth, giving us the wicked sarcastic laugh.
I hate that.
Always chops one off the knees. Kind of a half Heather thing.
I saw an ad the other day.
I hate that joke.
Have you guys been to Stingery?
Yes.
No. It's a hipster, kind of coolish bar, restaurant downtown. And it's a cool hang. I saw an ad for them the other day because DJ AM is going to be there. That's like...
Who?
Well, he's... He's, what's her name? Nicole Richie's, whatever.
That DJ
ex-boyfriend.
Yeah.
I can't believe they're taking out an ad going, there's going to be a DJ here playing records.
Well, we're so out of it. I mean, DJs, club DJs are all the rage. And they get the big buzz.
I'm not out of it. I totally know that. I don't get it.
Right.
I don't get it. Shouldn't it be the record that's the star? Oh. Listen to me.
Wow. Yeah.
The music is the star, not the DJ.
Half the guys that are rappers now used to be DJs
when
they
started. As you know, Mr. Dave Steve, you know, I mean, anyone can play the records, but it's the style and charisma from the guy up on the booth with the headphones and the sunglasses.
The way he goes,
yeah. And maybe a snippet, a sound bite between the records. The back cell. Come on, and time and temp.
Well, what's he got? Has he got an instant replay? Is he going to drop
boner? He's
going to drop that doesn't in between?
Have that. No.
No, but to play the music that keeps everybody dancing and dancing and dancing so you can't stop.
It's a skill, Dave.
Yeah.
Come on.
Ruthie, that's what the ecstasy does.
It's play sets.
I mean, what? You know, you're going to have a highly paid professional who's not going to come out of some 140 beat per minute song and drop in Having My Baby?
That's the thing. How hard can it be
what
to figure out?
Yeah.
Play records. Chicks are drunk. They'll dance.
But they get attention when they start getting followings.
That's what I don't get.
Well, that's what I'm telling you, that a lot of the rappers started as DJs and moved their way up.
Okay, look, you're not understanding what I'm saying. I'm aware of this. I just don't get it.
Oh, well, you need
I don't
up.
Get why these guys get any kind of attention. You go to a bar, the chicks are drunk, they want to dance, you put the music on, like Boyer said, as long as you don't drop Paul Anka in there, everyone's happy.
Well, perhaps then you should not be the program director at Stingery.
What do you
perhaps.
Mean?
Perhaps.
You should not be the person hiring the talent at Stingery.
You won't be getting a job there, Dave.
Whatever.
So, another career shot to hell.
That's sad. What will the future Mrs. R do when she wants to sue you for divorce?
Did you ever,
it's terrible.
Did you ever try to get a job as a club DJ?
I had to work in a club once as a DJ.
Did you?
Hi, welcome to Macayo's on Central Avenue in Phoenix. It's happy hour. Oh, it was death. Just horrible.
Oh, I tried to get one and nobody gave me a job.
It was just horrible.
I never did it before. I had no idea what I was doing.
I got like $5 an hour and you can go through the buffet. It's just awful.
I did it for a cup of coffee at a place in called Papagayo.
Yeah.
Nice.
In
La Jolla?
Nah, well, same name, I guess. This was in Milwaukee.
Oh, yeah.
And it's not hard.
Yeah.
It really isn't.
It just sucks.
You have two turntables
and a microphone.
You get special club mix versions of all the songs. Mm-hmm. And basically all they do is just start with a real long beat.
Right.
It just goes doof, 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 doof. And you have two turntables and you can adjust their speed.
Mm-hmm.
And so when song number one is ending going doof, 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 you get the second song to start with doof, doof, doof.
Right.
So you can't tell the difference between the two songs. It's that hard.
But you still have to play songs people like.
It's harder to walk out and get your newspaper. And it's not hard to choose songs people like.
They're drinking, Ruthie.
They
like
care.
Everything.
You know what songs people like? That's it.
They're drinking and trying to hook up.
These are made up jobs, made up celebrities, DJ AM. God. Well, I gotta be there. I want to hear how he goes from sexy back to Beyonce. I don't know how he does it.
I think we need to hear from the younger generation on this one.
They're not awake yet.
I'm not interested in what they gotta
Emily
say.
Emily goes to clubs and knows about DJs and
Emily, do you give
dancing?
A rat's ass about which DJ is working at what club?
No.
Thank you. Ruth, you've said nothing that makes sense all day today. Over.
Consistent.
Well, you want me to give the money back?
You just need to learn to scratch like the masters.
I want $225 million from you.
Yeah, right.
Come on now. Come on now.
Turn the tables and the microphone. That's awful. That's
terrible. What the hell are you playing?
It's off of YouTube. It's Learn to Scratch Like the Masters.
You can't dance to that.
This is quality stuff. Yeah, come on. Talk to me. Ruth.
Turn it off.
Oh. Hey, who change wanted to dance to that?
Not me.
You couldn't get drunk enough to dance to that.
That's what I'm saying.
You have to take the ecstasy to enjoy it.
That's exactly right.
Now here we go.
Is this Kathy P?
Yes, just believe it is.
There's a destination a little up the road from the habitations of the towns we know. Place we saw the lights turn low, the jigsaw jazz in the get fresh flow, pulling out jobs and jamboree handouts, two turntables and a microphone, bottles and cans, or just clap your hands, or just clap your hands.
Where's that?
I got two turntables and a microphone.
Where's that?
I got two turntables and a microphone.
Where's that?
I got two turntables and a microphone.
I'm just telling you, as a guy who's done it, as long as you got two hands, you can do this. You probably don't even need record players anymore. You could be the handless DJ.
That goes back to Ruthie's one-armed DJ. The treatment she's going to take meetings on.
Dear Dave, Juanita Jordan deserves $225 million because marriage is a partnership agreement between two people, regardless of who the breadwinner is.
Yeah.
Written by a woman.
Of course.
How about
Shelley? Next. Well, that's Shelley with two E's, but not.
No, that's wrong.
Dear Dave, you're trying to talk logic to broads. Give it up, bro. Love your show, John. Dear Dave, notice it's the Democrats on your show who want something for nothing.
What do you mean nothing? 18 years, best years of your life.
Yeah, the greatest years living with a rich bastard who
ruin
took care
your
of
body.
Huh?
Ruin your body.
What did you do to
our
body? What happened?
What do you do? Cut her up or something?
Cranking all those kids out.
She didn't have to do that. That was her choice.
How many kids does she have?
I don't know.
That was her choice.
More than two, so I call it a bunch.
You know what? I got to go back to trying to talk logic to broads. Give it up, bro. What's our top story in this morning's Half-Baked Crackpot News?
Well, if you're putting your house on the market, there's going to be trouble. Sales have plunged.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Not in San Diego.
This is national.
Well, who cares? I mean, seriously.
Well, I just maybe
having a hard time in Wichita. I don't really care.
Mm.
What's that thing that you can do where you
Zillow?
Zillow. I got to Zillow my house during the commercial break and see what happened.
What's that?
I'll bet you $5. It's dipped.
Yep.
Since the last time I looked.
Yeah.
What is that?
I checked Zillow on everything that I know. Right. And everything's down.
This Zillow. Is a great website, Ruthie. You can anyone's address that you have, you can Zillow their address in, and it'll tell you the approximate value.
That's not true, but a lot of people can.
Right.
You can have your house blocked from Zillow.
Oh.
Yeah.
Z blocker.
Well, I would. Geez, it's like having an unlisted phone number.
Yeah. I'm gonna have to do that during the commercial break and see where I'm at. My my thing with the Zillow thing was, see, they take an aerial picture or a satellite picture of your house, mm-hmm. and then they drop a number on it. Mm. But my house hasn't been updated since I added on to it.
See, that neither is ours. But I still psychologically, I have to not go. I have to stop doing it because I was doing it like every week, and it's freaking me out.
It's going down.
And all I've been doing is, with the addition that I did to my house, is I just add what it cost me.
Right.
On top whatever, of that. Yeah, to whatever it says.
Oh. But I don't know. It probably is worth more.
I don't know.
Have you been doing that show? Because you've certainly improved your house a lot.
Well,
how is your house, by the way? Are we talking about that yet?
I can't talk about it quite yet, but there is some redecorating going on.
All right. Are things good?
Well, we're meeting with contractors.
Okay.
We're
last of eight? What the hell are you talking about? Where you been?
Chatty over there.
You just put that up.
Break has been up there for a while. I just now let you know it was the last of eight.
Liar, whore, you know it.
You are correct, I guess.
Liar, whore, you know it.
Thanks a lot, Ruby. Love that.
You're not talking to us.
You would just let poor Michael Jordan keep his money. We could have been done with this and into commercials.
Oh, stupid me.
Money grubbing whores. She's a whore. She's a whore. I want to see that. That Sopranos, where Paulie goes freaking. She's a hooer. She was a hooer.
He said it this past week.
He did?
Yeah.
Who did he say it to?
Because they reminisced a lot, talked about old things. Oh, because they were going to go to that hooer house.
I just want to hear it when he was so outraged when he found out that his mother wasn't his mother. And just.
Yeah, all right.
She was a hooer. I got to get that. That's so great.
Can you make that your cell phone ring?
Oh.
Wouldn't it be cool?
Oh. Yeah, who are you going to tie that to when their number shows up on the display?
I don't think Nicole would like that. Mm-mm. Every time she calls me, it's a hooer.
But like every time I call, liar, whore, and you know it. That's Shelly. Send it to voicemail.
liar, whore, and you know it.
David, are you there?
David, hello.
Here's my ringtone for when Boyer calls me.
I mean, if you can't be at least mildly interesting, then shut the hell up.
Or sometimes we just go with a real short one.
Uh-huh. Ass.
It's Boyer.
Very accurate.
All right, quick time out here. We're on KGB and Q103. KGB and Q103, Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Radio Show. I just won $5 from the chainsaw.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Mine's up. But what I don't understand is it's a really old estimate because I'm looking at, like, you know, bare lots where houses are now.
Right.
So this picture is at least a year and a half old. Man, people are stealing houses in my neighborhood. This thing's very interesting because what it will do is it will list not only your house, the houses in your neighborhood. They'll tell you which houses are for sale, which houses recently sold, mm-hmm. what they were asking for, what they actually got. Man, holy cow. Someone stole a house in my neighborhood.
Everyone's doing that in my neighborhood and then knocking them down and building these little, you know, mini mansions.
So I'm up. Not as much as the chainsaw, though. Did you hear what happened?
No.
Last week.
Yes.
It's been updated. I am up $69.
Hey! Thank you. Yeah. Sell,
thank
man.
Thank you.
Don't wait.
Sell
right.
Sell
drop on. Everything right now and sell.
That's what I'm talking about.
I thought you were going to say $69,000.
$69.
Well, that's better than going down.
Nothing's better than going down.
People are like, I only lost 5 pounds. Well, that's better than gaining 5 or not losing any.
You are such an optimist.
What?
That's the first sensible thing she said
Thanks
all day.
You. Today.
Nicely done.
Where you been?
Rose.
All right. You ready with this morning's Half-Baked Crackpot News?
Indeed.
Drop it on me.
Well, despite what we just heard locally, the National Association of Realtors says sales plunged 8.4% in March to an annual rate of 6.12 million houses. They blame poor weather for the sharp March decline. At the same time, they say the median home price rose to $270,000. More American families grieving the loss of loved ones in Iraq. An insurgent group that includes Al-Qaeda in Iraq claimed responsibility for a bombing that killed 9 U.S. soldiers in Iraq yesterday. In addition to the 9 killed, 20 were hurt. That was the single deadliest strike on U.S. ground forces since December of 2005, when a roadside bomb killed 10 Marines on a foot patrol near Fallujah. And today, police say at least 15 people died after a suicide truck bomb exploded at a police checkpoint on the outskirts of Ramadi. On Capitol Hill, lawmakers plan to press Pentagon officials today about the death of Army Ranger Pat Tillman in Afghanistan. They want to know if a spy drone was flying overhead when he was killed and if it had videotape of the incident. Tillman died in friendly fire in 2004. It was first blamed on enemy fire. The Wiccan Pentacle has been added to the list of emblems allowed on national cemeteries and on government-issued headstones of fallen soldiers. A settlement between the U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs and Wiccans adds the five-pointed star to the list of emblems belief allowed on VA grave markers. 11 families nationwide have been waiting for grave markers with that emblem.
Holy crap!
What?
What happened, David?
I just found out one of my neighbor's house with this.
It kills you, doesn't it?
Jeez.
More or less.
More than yours?
About 18 times more than mine.
Jesus.
But in reality?
What?
It's not?
It's, I just can't believe there's a house that expensive anywhere.
Always good to have the dog on the block.
Oh, yeah. No doubt.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because part of this is based on comps in the neighborhood, what other people get.
Oh.
So that's good.
I know. I don't think people were too happy when I bought my house because I came along at the right time and I stole it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's what you do, though.
And people are like, oh, man, what'd you do that for? Yeah, you know, you're right. Yeah, I should have paid a lot more to keep you happy.
Didn't you go down the door, you know, door to door and say, hey.
Hey, you wouldn't mind if I paid like real little for this, would you? So I want to make sure I pay a price that makes you happy.
Make you happy. Mm-hmm. I'm worried about that.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, President Bush says he understands our frustrations that all Americans have, he says, with what's happening in Iraq.
People want our troops to come home, and so do I. But no matter how frustrating the fight can be, and no matter how much we wish the war was over, the security of our country depends directly on the outcome in Iraq.
Liar, whore, and you know it!
Now, that's not nice.
That's hurtful. President Bush said he listened to what we as Americans said as we voted last fall, but he claims the Democrats did not listen.
The American people did not vote for failure, and that is precisely what the Democratic leadership's bill would guarantee.
Open your eyes. It's failed.
Meanwhile, Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid says...
We can't
ever win. It's Senator Douche. Do you mind?
Senator Douche? I call him Harry Reid. You might call him Douche. Anyway.
No, it's not me. It's a Marine... Harry,
call him?
Harry has taken a lot of crap lately.
Yeah.
They've got cartoons of him climbing up on top of the Iwo Jima Memorial, tying a white flag up on the top of the American flag. And some Marine has been reading about Harry Reid and what he wants to do. And he wrote a flaming blog from a foxhole about how he's never been here. He doesn't know what it looks like. He doesn't know what's going on here. These people need us. They're working with us. They're cooperating with us. That kind of stuff.
Hmm. Well, Harry Reid, the senator from Nevada, says
even
the top U.S. military commander in Iraq agrees that the troop surge that President Bush ordered will not bring us victory.
There is no evidence that the escalation is working, and it should come as no surprise because General Petraeus has said the ultimate solution in Iraq is a political one, not a military one.
Meanwhile, Ohio Congressman, do you know him, Dennis Kucinich?
Yep.
He plans to introduce articles of impeachment against Vice President Cheney today.
Oh,
He's a vocal critic of the Bush administration's war in Iraq. He is again running for president. He says he'll hold a news conference to discuss his bid to oust Cheney.
You know him as the sexiest of the contenders.
Totally. And wasn't he the only single one? And he's like, I'm looking for a date. And nobody took him up on it.
Was Kucinich the guy who was running for president and brought a pie chart to
on a
radio
interview?
Show?
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
Yep. Gets my vote right there.
The sexy vote alone. Also on Capitol Hill today, from deadly spinach, pet food, tainted peanut butter, incidents of contamination have raised questions not only about our food supply in the country, but about our government's efforts to keep our food safe. A House Energy and Commerce Subcommittee hearing today will focus on the Food and Drug Administration's oversight of what we Americans
eat. Hold on, I gotta eat something.
Look what happened to her.
It was pet food.
She shouldn't have been eating the cat food.
It was Alpo
Anna
that
Nicole,
took Anna down.
Stop it.
Oh. Like my body.
Yes.
Big news for Toyota. The Japanese automaker sold more cars and trucks than GM in the first quarter of 2007 for the first time, selling 2.3 million vehicles. GM close, but 2.2 million vehicles. A state assembly here in California committee has voted to phase out sales of the standard incandescent light bulb in our state. The Utilities and Commerce Committee approved a bill yesterday. It would bar sales of those bulbs in California stores starting in 2012. And the San Diego City Council today will consider whether to give city firefighters a pay raise, but our mayor objects. Firefighters in San Diego have not had a raise in 2 years. The Firefighters Local 145 seeks a 6% pay raise for its members in the fiscal year 2008.
Firefighters.
Who needs it?
Try hitting the post sometime, pal. I'm doing the time and
try
ten.
Running into a flaming record, okay?
Yeah, you know what? You didn't hear the Stingray promoting the guys from Station 10 are going to be here tonight.
Damn right. It's a DJ that's getting all the buzz,
you.
Man.
Mm-hmm.
I believe the song goes, the DJs are the heroes. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So why don't you just scrub down your yellow rubber pants?
Damn it.
The only way they can do that. I forget it.
Go ahead.
No.
Oh, I was talking to Shelly.
Oh, you're not encouraging you. Him.
Successfully looked away.
Kim is now suing Alex insane, using Alex's insane voicemail message to his daughter to score family court points by pretending she now fears for her daughter Ireland's safety. Of course, I'm talking about Alec Baldwin and Kim Basinger. So now Kim has hired a security guard to watch over Ireland.
Sure, you get it.
24/7.
Then I'm going to get on a plane. I'm going to turn around and I'm going to come home.
Okay.
You better be ready Friday, the 20th, to meet with me. So I'm going to let you know just how I feel about what a rude little pig you really are. You are a rude, thoughtless little pig, okay?
To replay this message.
Yeah, let's hit it again.
So Kim released a statement yesterday.
And what did she? I didn't do it.
Well, in part, she denied leaking this to the press.
Naturally.
But then she says, quoting here, Kim's sincerest wish for Alec is to finally address his unstable and irrational behavior so he at some point can potentially create a relationship with his daughter.
Relationship.
Until then, Kim will continue to protect and safeguard her child's well-being as any parent would. Alec has been ordered to stay away from his daughter pending a May 4th hearing. Baldwin has blamed Basinger for the leak. He also apologized on his own website for, quote, losing my temper with my child. Former American Idol contestant Sanjina read Dave Letterman's top 10 list last night.
You know what, Shelly? We got a break before we hear that, okay? But
right.
We will come back with Sanjina from Late Night last night next here on KGB.
Hi, Braves fans. It's Trevor Hoffman.
Hey, wake up. It's Trevor time. When those Dodgers come to town, I want to see you at Petco Park.
It's Rivalry Weekend presented by Bank of America when the Dodgers come to town, April 27th, 28th, and 29th. On Friday, April 27th, it's Trevor Hoffman night, and all fans get a Trevor time desk clock. Saturday is Mexico opening night with family fireworks. Get your tickets at Padres.com or 1-877-FRIAR-TIX.
Padres baseball. Experience it.
Coming to you from San Diego's 101 KGB and Temecula's Q103. It's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw with you. And tomorrow is Wednesday. That means Chris Boyer and company, they are going to go go-karting. You got it, buddy. Sorry. I was starting to anticipate your, you got it, buddy. You got it, buddy.
We're taking it to the indoor quarter-mile asphalt track, the Miramar Speed Circuit. We race there every Wednesday. I get to bring 10 listeners with me. We're going to buy you lunch. Everything is paid for by the KGB and
buddy.
San Diego Motorcycle Towing.com. They're there to give your motorcycle or jet ski a lift when you need it the most. San Diego Motorcycle Towing.com brings you this great free event, and you can get registered any time of the day by going to 101KGB.com and signing up. I'm making my calls on Mondays. Get ready.
All right. We have more news for you, including this appearance now from deposed American Idol Sanjina.
I never thought they'd vote him off, but America spoke, and so now he's doing his...
America voted.
America voted, and now he's doing his 15 minutes of fame, and last night it was on the Letterman Show, where all Sanjina right. did Letterman's top 10 list.
Top 10 things I learned from American Idol. Number 10.
The camera adds 10 pounds to your mohawk.
Yeah. And number 9.
Work hard and make sacrifices. You can finish in 7th place.
Why not?
More Sangina now, and Paul, the band leader, joins in during the broadcast.
And number six.
On camera, Simon's a bit nasty, but off camera, he's a total jerk.
Well, there you go. You see?
I knew it.
That explains everything.
I knew it
as well.
There's Paul. More Sangina reading the top 10 on Letterman Live.
Number four.
When you forget the words, just do this. Oh, oh, oh. Yes, you do.
I like that.
We found ourselves a new superstar.
Yeah.
Forget Idol. We got him.
Yeah.
And this will wrap it up, Sangina.
Things I have learned from American Idol, number two.
Nothing.
All right. And the number one thing I have learned from American Idol.
America loves performers with bad hair. Right, Dave?
What?
Hey.
There's no reason why you should be walking around with a loose vagina.
That's what I learned.
A loose Sangina.
Speaking of American Idol, Taylor Hicks worked his whole life for fame, and because of AI, he finally got it, but then he freaked out. AP Music correspondent Margie Zarletta reports.
Says when he was on American Idol, he and the other contestants got very famous very quickly, so they'd go on the internet to see what people were saying about them. He says that came to an end when he searched for himself and found he was one of the top five stories of the day.
Number one, of course, the war in Iraq, and then two, this and that, three, four, and then five is like American Idol dancer, funky dancer, and I just, that was it. I didn't go back there.
Hicks says he doesn't watch Idol now because he's always on stage when it's on, and he's only kind of heard of Sangina. I'm Archie Zarletta.
Yeah, shut up.
Come on.
Have two.
Give me a break.
You know, it's not going to hurt your mediocre fame to admit that you still watch the show and you've heard of other competitors. Lame ass.
Oh, damn.
Harsh. Sam Elliott in life and Steve McQueen in death, both inducted into
Beef.
The Hall of Great Western Performers. They were honored at the annual Western Heritage Awards, where Elliott was also the...
What's MC. My wife's name?
I don't know.
Catherine Ross.
Catherine Ross. That's what's for dinner. That's what I'm having. How about you?
What you got in there, good day?
Catherine Ross.
The fancy footwork is coming from the athletes on Dancing with the Stars. Still, the judges couldn't agree.
Best show ever.
Mm-hmm. They couldn't agree because Layla Ali came in with sort of a funky style.
All right.
I'm going to be honest with you. I can't tell a lie. Your bit at the end there that you choreographed wasn't really my cup of tea. The rest of it
was funky. It was sexy.
He should die.
He should die. Ali says she's at a disadvantage because there were only two women left in the competition.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry, I get excited when we talk about Layla.
I know you
do. It's fine. I always look at myself as an individual because this is a competition, but of course, you know, I know that ladies have it harder because the eye is on us and we have a lot more that we have to do, so I'm trying to just hang in here to the end.
I'm watching you, baby.
But you still love Heather the most, right? Heather is... She's the only other woman.
It's a good thing that Kathy Lee Gifford isn't on that show.
I think it'll happen next season. I know.
Would you stop? Wait a minute. You're not saying Kathy Lee Gifford is going to be on Dancing with the Stars because she is. I don't know what to watch.
I don't know.
Does that mean you guys elected me like you're my mother? No!
Yeesh. Blah, blah, blah.
I bet it'll happen. I bet they will hear your cry for Kathy Lee Gifford and put her on the show next season. But the judges got in a squabble over Apollo, his use of a chair as a prop during his routine.
What number is this?
10.
We do... don't have tears.
I would have liked a little bit more dancing on your two legs and not the four legs of the chair.
Come on,
well,
man.
No, it was a dance competition, Sunshine.
Why didn't you get a bed? You could have had a bed out there.
It's so fun listening to like...
nine people talk at once.
You know, one idiot talk. Let's make five idiots talk all at the same time.
Ready?
Like this show.
Okay, so I don't even...
But Apollo says it's no easier for him just because he's a world-class athlete.
Every single dance is different, has its own type of different problem that I bring to the table.
Look at my
own
support. I like that little thing.
You know what?
Nice.
Yes.
Good God.
didn't even hear him. What's his name?
Lest you've forgotten exactly how awesome it must be to be
Stop
Jack Nicholson.
Stop it, boys.
I can't help it.
Yes, you can.
She's just excited, down. Ruthie. Acceptance.
Sorry.
Nicholson, Jack, threw himself.
You're not sorry. Stop it.
A $950,000 party on Sunday to celebrate birthday number 70. Almost $1 million, $950,000. He hired 70 scantily clad waitresses, one for every year of his life, to wait on all of his guests.
How do you spend $1 million on a party?
I think the waitresses are union, and he had to pay them very much
money. You sure about that number?
And good food.
Yeah. And it's...
Twanky place.
It doesn't say at a source, but that's what my sheet here says.
Shoot, what do you want to spend up that money if you were that old?
Well, you got hookers, you got the cocaine, you got the dancing girls.
Yeah, it still shouldn't cost $1 million.
You got maybe there, I don't know, maybe entertainment. What about that one guy who hired Jimmy Buffett for like a gazillion dollars to play at his wife's birthday party?
That will draw drive the price up, definitely, if you hire like a big-name entertainer who's going to be in a six-figure thing. But I can't even imagine how you spend that much.
I would love to try.
I mean, I'm throwing a pretty big wing ding later this year, and it's like...
Have you added up the price yet? Do you have a mental tally in your head?
I have I have an idea where it's going to come in.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're not there yet, so we haven't gone over that.
Yeah.
But, no, I'm keeping a tally.
Yeah.
So what's the matter?
I have a file, and I can't bear to add it up yet.
Why?
That's
the first thing I did when I finished my home edition, because you know there's so many different things.
I've done that.
You know, when you do a construction project on your house, the concrete is a separate thing.
Right.
Painting is a separate thing.
Oh, you're writing checks left and right.
Framing is a different thing. Roofing is a different thing.
And roof.
When I got those all finally done, and I got the last one in, I couldn't wait to sit down and see what it all added up to.
I did that with the outdoor kitchen that we did.
Yeah.
And that was bad enough. I said, I can't go to the wedding now. I can't.
Why?
Because I don't need to know. I need to put a little time between it, and then I'll be able to add it up.
Really?
Figure it out. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I'd be dying to know.
In between the honeymoon and all of that.
Yeah. I'm putting everything on there. The ring, everything.
Right. Right.
Oh, it'll drive the price up. It's like, yeah.
No kidding. Well, it's
not like it was free.
Right.
Let's move on to number 13. Anna Nicole Smith's final movie, Illegal Aliens, out on DVD May 1st. Hold your breath.
Yes.
We get comments from her co-stars, from AP correspondent Rosalie Fox.
The people who worked with Anna Nicole Smith on the low-budget B-movie comedy Illegal Aliens are praising her work ethic.
Why's my pippy hat sore?
One of her co-stars, Gladys Jimenez, says Smith was not a prima donna and she came to the set focused and ready to work. Another co-star, Lanise Seren, says Smith always...
Who can tell me what she was saying there?
Can't. Get in spit takes, do like the baby balls, talk. And be silly. Rosalie Fox, Los Angeles.
And we'll move on to cut number 15 now. They said it wouldn't last, and in the end, sadly, it didn't. AP Urban correspondent Oscar Wells Gabriel.
I'm Oscar Wells Gabriel.
...on the end of the marriage of two troubled pop stars.
Oh, no.
It's the day it all ends for Whitney Houston and Bobby Brown, at least in the eyes of the courts.
Yeah.
It's the day their divorce becomes final.
Divorce.
Earlier this month,
you're divorced, crud.
A court judge in Orange County, California,
sorry, darn it,
said today it's the day it takes effect.
That Oscar Wilde.
Chapter in the marriage of the two pop stars after 14 years. When the ruling was announced, Houston was in court dabbing at her eyes with a tissue.
Oh, Bobby stop
Brown
it.
Didn't bother to show up. I'm Oscar Wells Gabriel.
So much he cares.
That was there in court, and I handed her my ascot to dab at her voice and eyes. I'm Oscar Wells Gabriel.
I wonder how much Bobby Brown got.
Good question.
Yeah.
I'm sure he deserved all of that. It was $255 million.
The man has crack to buy. Come on. A piece of movie history goes up for sale in Oregon. Alan Skaya now with that story.
Ruth, do you think Bobby Brown deserves half of Whitney Houston's money?
Aha. Aha. Reflex.
Ruthie.
Deserves.
Yeah.
It was there.
Right, exactly. I just think of the key word, deserves.
Oh.
He was a very bad man.
Interesting.
He did very bad things.
What did he
like,
do?
Like what?
What did he do?
Unlike Mrs.
What did he do?
Whitney was a Girl Scout.
What did he do?
Well, I know she didn't earn a lot of money the last few years, but too busy doing drugs.
What did he do?
He cheated on her, and he didn't work.
just a big low for goof off.
Huh. Well, that's what Juanita Jordan did, was a big low for goof off.
And he kept getting arrested and not paying his child support and getting arrested.
Child support? Wait, they're not even, divorced until today.
No, but the couple of other kids he had with other women.
That doesn't happen.
Well, that's got nothing to do with Whitney Houston.
Well, no, but that got him arrested a couple times while he was married. I'm telling you, that's why he doesn't deserve it, because he was not a good husband.
Well, that needs a man.
But, Ruthie, he was there for the same part of the marriage that
doesn't matter.
Mrs. Jordan was there with Michael.
Mrs. Jordan was a great wife.
The same logic does not apply.
She never got arrested.
You have to imply the reverse if you follow the other way.
Here's the way it works. The woman gets the money. The man doesn't get buckus.
See, that's not fair.
Too bad.
It's got to apply to the man and the woman.
He's a criminal.
Tough titties.
He's not in jail, Ruthie.
He went to jail. A whole bunch of times.
But he served society. Can you not be rehabilitated?
Yeah, no. Ruth.
And she, Whitney took him back.
He gets nothing, Ruth.
But he gets nothing.
No, he probably gets something.
They have a child together.
Ruth.
Yes, they do. Mm-hmm. He has a bunch of kids.
He don't get nothing. You don't get a thing, you punk.
Whitney and Bobby Brown have kids?
Yeah, they have a daughter.
Yeah.
And then he has about three other kids from his other relationships.
Maybe more, we just don't know.
Didn't you watch that reality show?
You know, I did.
A couple of episodes. It's just,
it comes out right before Dancing.
No, networks actually didn't pick it up.
All right.
This is a piece of movie history up for sale in Oregon, and Alan Skaya has the story.
It's a 16?
Yes.
It feels so good to be back here at the Dexter Lake Club.
The Dexter Lake Club appeared in scenes from Animal House. Filmmakers shot the movie at sites around Eugene. Uh-huh. When members of Delta House went on a road trip, they found their favorite music group at the club. Otis Day and the Knights were performing.
Shamalama ding dong.
The Dexter Lake Club stands near Highway 58 outside Eugene. Yeah, really? Scenes at the club have attracted criticism for their racial insensitivity.
We're the only white people here.
But that criticism hasn't stopped the owners from listing the site at $259,000.
I need to do
it. Alan Skaya,
that
Portland.
Dump? Wasn't it a dump? Like a little dive bar.
It's movie history.
Oh.
But there are some who are putting their family before the television. That is the goal for more than 70 national organizations this week. Brother. Who cares? Roger Hudson is back with that report.
Where have I been?
I don't know.
Oh.
Turn off all your electronic gadgets and turn to your family and friends for company.
What for?
The driving human message behind TV turnoff week.
There's no question that we are truly addicted to these devices.
But not just your TV, according to Robert Keston, executive director of Screen Time Awareness. He says Americans focus an additional 8 hours every day to computers, iPods, video games, and cell phones.
If you keep it to 2 hours or less a day, you'll really be mentally and physically much healthier.
Shut up,
organized groups like the Scouts, churches, hospitals, and libraries agree with Keston, saying people no longer talk to each other, they talk around them.
What's
Roger Hudson,
that?
Houston.
Nothing wrong with that. Perfect.
I just wanted
to hear Roger Hudson.
Why do all those guys sound so weird, all the reporters? Why do they all have such odd voices?
Coming to you from the Department of No Fun, please turn off all your electronic devices.
For a week.
Finally this morning, once you've turned off, you can tune in. Stoners at RollingStone.com have graced us with their list of the greatest songs to listen to while you're high.
Oh, goody.
I'll skip the top 25 and go right to the top 10. Number
Grateful
10.
Grateful Dead.
There is no Grateful Dead that I can see on here.
What a sham.
Yeah, you know why? Because their music sucks even when you are blasted.
No.
Number 10, Nothing But a G Thang by Dr. Dre.
Hang on, I should play some of these for you.
Okay.
Nothing but a G thing. That song's okay. Not the best.
Well, I guess
I
don't have to play it now.
How about, do you have Radiohead? Everything is in its right place.
What is it? Nothing but a what?
Nothing but a G thing.
Great song.
Well, how come we don't have it?
It might be Nuttin, N-U-T-T-I-N.
Oh, God. I hate this thing. What else?
Radiohead, Everything in Its Right Place.
I don't even want to know that.
Feeling All Right, Joe Cocker. Well, you are high.
Oh, that's a good song.
I like that song.
I like that song.
Great piano.
You know what? I bought that song with my own money.
I did. It's got great piano in it.
I saw Joe Cocker sing that song.
I saw Joe Cocker throw up, okay? That's all he ever did on stage.
Phenomenal.
Summertime by Janis Joplin.
What one?
Summertime.
Good Lord.
Oh, I love that song.
That is one of
my
favorite.
Wait. Songs. Let's see. I don't even know this song.
We played on KGB.
And the living is and the living is easy.
It's from
the Broadway show.
Janis Joplin. And it's not on here.
Oh.
Not here.
She just wrecked it with her drunken, vomitous, terrible.
If only is she it, and Joe Cox
had fun in the summertime?
No.
Which one is it?
Summertime and the living is easy.
Well, what does she sing good?
Everything.
She screeches and squeals.
Are you kidding,
Earth?
You're back to making no sense today.
She's one of my all-time favorites. There were like no girl groups way back when. She was one of the few. But I still love her.
Oh, no girl groups. Let's see. The Supremes.
She's no Kathy Lee Gifford, though.
That was in the 60s. I'm talking about rocker girls.
Yeah, that would be Janis Joplin, late 60s. Supremes, Diana Ross, Jefferson Airplane. Joan Baez.
Yeah, but besides them, Joni
Mitchell.
Nothing.
Dusty Springfield.
No, doesn't count.
I give you like Jackie her. DeShannon.
Nothing.
Okay, now let's start naming guy bands and
can't
you go
on
forever.
Can't think of one.
Number six is Slow Ride by Foghat.
Oh Jesus.
Number five.
Wait. Did I just get an Oh Jesus?
Yes.
Slow Ride is
great. I used to love Slow Ride.
Yeah, but if I didn't hear him 14 million times.
Oh. Slow Ride is
you're high. You've forgotten all of it. Remember, it's from RollingStone.com.
Slow Ride is the ultimate sex
it's
song.
Totally great.
I heard it way too much.
And you turn it up really loud. That's my parents would get mad.
Radio ruined
it. It was great.
Okay.
White Rabbit by Jefferson Airplane.
Good one.
Purple Haze by Jimi Hendrix. Some band called Spiritualized, and it's number three is Ladies and Gentlemen, We Are Floating in Space.
Don't know it.
Number two is Pack the Pipe by The Far Side, spelled with P-H.
Pack the Pipe.
The
Liberace song, I think.
Yeah. And the number one song, according to the stoners at RollingStone.com, to listen to when you're high is... Shine On You Crazy Diamond, parts 1 through 5,
yes.
Pink Floyd.
I like number 4 the best.
Purple Haze.
Ever since Carl's Jr. put that chick on the rodeo, the rodeo bull eating a hamburger. You kidding me?
I think they know their demographic.
Snare.
Chainsaw Sports comes up next here. It's KGB. Q103.
Take it easy. I don't want to meet you here.
San Diego.
Dave Shelley Chainsaw.
We'll be right back.
KGB.
Facing a divorce, custody, or child support issue, don't go it alone. You need the professionals at 1-800-DIVORCE.
Choosing the right attorney for divorce or custody issues is one of the most important decisions a man can make. I am Bill Goldberg of the law firm Goldberg & Jones. The impact of a divorce can last a lifetime. I tell clients, check out all their options. Once they understand the law, we help them make intelligent decisions.
Call 1-800-DIVORCE. Get your phone questions answered at no charge. That's 1-800-DIVORCE, serving the entire greater San Diego area.
Call 1-800-DIVORCE.
Open a Wells Fargo Home Equity account today and get their free home improvement kit, where you'll find lots of great money-saving ideas and get access to their special home improvement website. Seize your someday. Wells Fargo. The next stage.
What's the harder part for you when you come back from vacation? Is it the Monday or is it the second day?
Oh, Monday, definitely.
Second day?
Tuesday.
Tuesday for me kills me every time.
Way harder.
I was a little bit kind of like out of my mind yesterday, but I felt good. Tuesday's always tough. I was thinking about that. And then I thought, well, at least I'm not poor Chris Boyer, who spent an entire week of making pots of coffee.
That's got to be exhausting.
Yeah. And then trying to come back.
You know, but it's pretty easy. All you have to do is just sit at home, dump 6 scoops in, 6 cups of water, and brew and you go. And you can have your coffee any way you want, right in the comfort of your own home with Coffee Mate.
Uh-huh.
Over 25 different flavors, summer seasonal specialties. Everyone is going to make a great part of your day. And when you add a little Coffee Mate, the bottom of that cup before you pour in the coffee. Coffee Mate is coffee's perfect mate, and it does something special
good
for you.
Good question. What's the proper protocol? Does the Coffee Mate go in first?
Yes, it does.
Why?
Because that way when you dump the coffee in, the turbidity...
David.
Now, are we talking about the liquid Coffee Mate or the powdered Coffee Mate?
Either one. You put it in first. That way you can measure it out properly.
Measure it out?
And that's the wrong word. I've used that word improperly. I've picked the wrong
word.
Well,
then it's chin-dong time.
Yes, it is.
How dare you use improper grammar during an ad-lib spot?
Yeah, I know.
Songaholic.
We need an intervention.
So you just pour in a little coffee, measure it out right, dump the coffee
measure?
In.
Oh, my God. He says measure.
Measure. Well, you check how much you're going to put in, right?
No, I mean, measure.
You measure
it out. What are you, an old lady from Wichita?
I got to measure it out before I see my stories with my coffee mate.
What do you measure?
Perfect mate.
You just put a little bit in the bottom. You wait till there's sort of a meniscus on it.
Oh,
meniscus?
Shut up.
Meniscus is a cartilage.
No, it's not.
It's not. It's the skin, right? It's the dome of a bubble formed by a liquid in a vessel.
Ew.
He's right.
Sorry, it is. Anyway.
It's the concave dome.
Sounds gross.
I think it's convex. It comes up over the top.
Jesus.
I thought it came up to the sides.
Right now?
I thought it crept up to the sides. No?
I think it's a bubble up top.
Okay.
I believe it is.
Anyway, you can
find out for yourself for free with Coffee Mate when you go to coffee-mate.com for your own free 7-day supply. Save the time, save the money. Don't go to those expensive coffee shops. You're going to save $1,200 a year when you go to coffee-mate.com and find your coffee's perfect mate with your own free 7-day supply of Coffee Mate.
Concave. Convex, meniscus, and turbidity.
Yes.
Coffee Mate will be signing up again for sure. Let's roll out sports for you right now here on the KGB and Q103. Here's the Chainsaw. Go, Bolton.
Well, good morning, and thank you very much, Dave Rickard, Shelly Dunn, Chris Boyer, Ruth 66. Hello again, everybody. In the sports world, the Padres resume action tonight in Arizona. Classic pitching matchup, David Wells versus Randy Jackson. Padres D-backs first pitch 6:40 tonight, our time, on Channel 4. Yankee superstar A-Rod tattooed two more taters in a loss to Tampa Bay yesterday. A-Rod ties the Major League record for homers in April with 14, and he has 6 games left to break that record. At this pace, A-Rod would finish this season with 126 homers, 306 RBI, and a .400 batting average. Let's see if he can keep that pace.
That's insane. You're stupid.
I know that. I'm very well aware. Meanwhile, in the National Bank...
If you've never had the opportunity to see the inside of a Major League locker room, you're missing out. I suggest that since you may not have access, most people don't, you gotta head down to a local gym. Spend some time in the showers. Listen for the sounds of slapping flesh.
Oh.
Sense the tangy bouquet of aftershave and body spray.
Oh.
Relish the musky mist that hangs and hovers. The 0-1 just low, one ball, one strike. And I've been noticing Harris's firm backside. After every swing, his tot biscuits do a little jiggle. A rapid boing. A teeny-weeny wiggle-waggle that really adds to the flavor of the game. When you add that spectacle to the surrounding tastes, smells, and sounds, it really makes a meal, folks. Man, oh man. Lund, now set, looking. Kicks and fires a rocket. A fastball just missing the inside corner, 2-1. Jeremy Lund. Remarkable ball control. His balls today, quite impressive. Rising and falling with each offering. I notice he likes to moisten, spitting on, and rubbing his balls all afternoon.
Ew.
The 2-1 foul backing out of play in the count evens.
Skipball Association. Throw up Ruth in playoff last night. Playoff action. Pistons Tony D'Orlando and Houston razzed the Jazz. Ruthie's Lakers visit Phoenix tonight. They're down 0-1. 7:30 on TNT. Chance to see Ruth's ex-boyfriend, Luke Walton, in action, along with his sidekick, Kobe Bryant. And
stop it.
The 2-time MVP, Steve Nash, for the Suns.
Hate Steve Nash.
Other sports, David.
Looked up meniscus for you, Chainsaw.
Yes.
And, Chris, you said it is what?
It is the little bubble formed at the top of a liquid in a column, which is a convex
or concave.
Oh, crap, I think you're right.
Really? Because before, when I had suggested that, you said, no, I insist that I'm right. I know I am.
You're right.
I'm certain of it. Because, in fact, it's the convex or concave upper surface of a column of liquid.
Yes, it's chin dong time.
Come on.
Strapping it on. You don't know crap. You were totally wrong. Yeah. Yes, it's chin dong time. Wouldn't you know? Put the wiener on and you're ready to go. Yes, it's chin dong. Chin dong.
Doing like Gwen Stefani, little disco thing. Mark him down. He owes us a quarter hour to start of tomorrow's show.
No, I mean, it's this time, right?
That's too bad.
Yes, it is.
And it is also anatomically a disc of cartilage, David.
Yes,
so
it is.
So I avoided the chin dong with my assertion.
That's right. No, you were right, Chang.
It is 10:14 and 16 seconds. This is your
101.5
KGB Sports Network. Oh, my.
And the chainsaw is brought to you by Trophies, America's original sports grill. If you haven't tried Trophies' new happy hour food and drink specials yet, maybe you can win a happy hour for your entire office. Just register online at 101kgb.com. Either way, you're a winner with Trophies' happy hour. Your table's ready at Trophies.
Someday, the TV room and the playroom and the home office and the family room won't all be the same room. But why wait for someday? Open a Wells Fargo Home Equity account today and you'll get our free home improvement kit. You'll find lots of great money-saving ideas and get access to our special home improvement website. Seize yours someday. Call, click, or stop by and talk to Wells Fargo about a home equity account today. Wells Fargo, the next stage. Wells Fargo Bank, N.A., member FDIC, equal housing lender. Offer good while supplies last.
Yeah, sure. So you want me to describe my world in 10 words or less? Rock, hard rock, classic rock, country rock, alternative rock. You know, stop me when I get to 10 here.
Whatever your world is about, AT&T can deliver it at the speed you need. Love music? Then here's the perfect way to explore a whole world of music fast and access it even faster. Sign up for AT&T Yahoo High-Speed Internet, the fastest internet in town for the price, and wireless from the new AT&T, and get one free year of unlimited music from Napster. That's fast access to over 3 million songs you can take on the go. Jazz, hip-hop, country, whatever you want. Yeah, including rock. Go to att.com/freemusic or visit a singular store near you. AT&T is the most complete provider for the way you live with TV, broadband, home phone, and wireless. The new AT&T. Your world? Delivered.
Comparison of major broadband providers. Express speed or higher requires purchase of Sync phone and 2-year term for new wireless customers. Other restrictions apply. For details, call 1-866-416-6471 toll free or visit att.com/offer details.
Have a good night's sleep.
There's one station that brings you the information that matters to you. The news that makes a difference in your life. The talk that you care about. Set a preset for AM 600 KOGO. AM 600 KOGO. San Diego's news and talk station.
Fly Southwest Airlines from San Diego to Houston. With 10 flights a day to Houston Hobby, including their new daily nonstop June 4th, Southwest Airlines is taking low fares farther. Visit southwest.com today and plan your next trip to Houston. You are now free to move about the country.
If you're interested in construction, get to the Construction Expo this Saturday at Qualcomm Stadium. It's filled with dazzling displays and amazing job opportunities for men.
And women, too.
Meet construction pros. See live demonstrations. Check out the latest tools and equipment, plus plenty of tasty foods and chances to win thousands of dollars in prizes. Construction Expo 2007. Free admission and free parking. This Saturday from 8:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. at Qualcomm Stadium. To find out more about the construction opportunities, visit Hop Building Career.
The best new cars make the best used cars.
We've got it. Yeah, we've got it.
And Toyota certified used vehicles are the best. Take a closer look. All Toyota certified used vehicles come with a 160-point quality inspection, a vehicle history report, a 3-month, 3,000-mile comprehensive warranty, a 7-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty, plus 24-hour roadside assistance. Upon closer inspection, it's easy to see why over 1.5 million TCUVs have been sold in America. So get a great deal on a certified used Toyota car, truck, or SUV. Based on AutoData Corp cumulative data for certified used sales, comprehensive warranty from date of certified purchase, powertrain warranty and roadside assistance from date when first sold as new. For details, see your San Diego County Toyota dealer. Toyota, moving forward.
Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw.
I think we're going to be needing a squeegee later.
There's something very uncomfortable about all this.
The DSC.
Congratulations, idiot.
We've been trying to please you.
You think you have the answers to everything.
Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw. KGB.
Hey, you know what else I watched last night? It's a pretty good show. Haven't seen this before. The New Adventures of the Old Christine.
Yeah.
I think Julia Louis-Dreyfus has a real shot at busting the Seinfeld curse. I watched the show last night, and it's good.
It's fun.
It's really good. I mean, it's in a hell of a time slot. It's got a real shot at winning. It's, I think it was one of the lead-up shows to Two and a Half Men last night. So there was New Adventures of Old Christine, How I Met Your Mother, which is going to drive me crazy. I will not watch that show at Two and a Half Men. That's pretty a good show, though. Have you seen it?
Yes, I have.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's funny.
She is funny.
And she doesn't annoy me on this show like she did in the end as Elaine. I like her,
She, you know, Elaine got pissy at the end of Seinfeld.
I hated her pushing people all the time. Like, get out! Stop it!
Yeah.
You're a violent woman.
Yeah, that'd been around for a while. But she got pissy towards the end. She got intolerant.
Yeah,
it's a good show. That's worth checking out. The New Adventures of Old Christine.
And I love her live-in brother, too. And Weeds is back on.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Right on.
Yeah.
How about the guy who's married to three different women?
Oh, I never
Nicole's
watched
favorite
that.
Show.
Yeah, my friend Shannon watches that, loves that.
Big Love. It's not, didn't start the new season yet.
All right, I'm going to give you your Gwen Stefani disco.
Oh, yay.
Boops. How's it go? Boop, boop, boop.
I got to hear the Chin-Dun song to do it.
All right, let me thank our sponsors for today's show. We are grateful to them today. If only Emily had highlighted them for me.
Oh.
I'll do my best. What? Why are you looking at me? What's with the glasses? Don't give me that bookish librarian little scowl. What's with the specs there?
I got them yesterday.
I like them. Good new glasses. But no, you didn't highlight this thing.
I don't normally, and I didn't realize it wasn't this morning. Either.
Oh, I thought you did that.
No. I can help
I stand
you.
Corrected. Why don't you do them for me? Okay. I would appreciate that. But don't, you can't repeat.
Okay.
You got to know which ones you've done.
Trophies.
And screw it up.
Harrah's Rincon Casino. UPS Store. Bank of America. BMW. Coffee Mate. Honda Dealers of San Diego. Massey Nissan. Chapman University. The Zoological Society of San Diego.
It's zoological.
That too.
Shut up, lawyer.
With a chin dog on.
And Western Lexus Dealer.
Thank you, Emily. I like it when you do the sponsors. It's very good. Good job. Here comes Cindy Pace. Next on 101 KGB San Diego. Jeff Gonser and company in Temecula on KTMQ Temecula. And we're on again tonight at 7 o'clock. Are we going over the hump already?
Oh, yeah.
Tomorrow. We'll see you at 5. Love your show.
101.5 KGB.
With another loot chip word.
Nerve. N-E-R-V-E. Nerve.
Not a blue chip VIP?
Click on 101kgb.com. Keyword blue chip.
And listen again at 1 to win.
From 101.5 KGB.
San Diego.
If I live without you, I live without love.